Live from the Angry Beagle Studios is the Beans and Rocket Show.
Welcome to Beans and Rocket, take two.
What the hell is going on tonight? All right, well, let me tell you, it is episode 80, and on tonight's show,
yes,
we've got Elmer versus the Bully.
That's right.
Our favorite memories. And our last show.
Well, hell yeah.
So
stay tuned, bitches.
Live from the Angry Beagle Studios is the Beans and Rocket Show.
Rocket Show! It's
the
final episode!
Oh, shit.
Now, Rocket! If they're watching us live right now, how can they watch us live?
I'm sorry, can you say that again? I feel like I didn't hear you the first two times. If you're watching us live right now, you can catch us on Facebook Live. If you want to watch us later, you can always catch us on Vimeo and iTunes. If you want to listen to us later, you can catch us on iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, TuneIn, Google Play Music, and my balls.
Although, you know what?
What's that?
I'm pretty sure if I put my ear next to your balls, I'm not going to hear the show.
Would you like to try?
No. Kate, give it a shot.
Right.
Kate's like, I don't really want to.
She always has a look of fear in her eyes, so it's kind of hard to gauge whether or not it's because of me. Or
there's one person that's happy that this show is coming to an end.
Kate is like, Kate. Woo! Yes.
Finally, I can relax on a Wednesday.
Confetti.
Yes, we are making it rain because it's our final episode.
All right.
Ashley and Matt are laughing at us because little known fact for people that are watching later on the recorded version is we forgot to hit record, so we had to redo this whole section.
Yes.
Right now, it's brand new to Ash and Matt.
This is new.
So, Rocket, tell us, what are we drinking tonight?
Oh, let me tell you right now. It's Suntory Toki.
Oi!
Japanese whiskey, right?
Oi!
You gotta get in there. You gotta
whiskey
build that
song.
Intense. The appearance, color clear and gold. Nose, aroma, smell. Basil, green, apple, honey. Flavor, taste, and palate. Grapefruit, green grapes, peppermint, and thyme.
You're throwing a little Arnold in there.
Finish.
I'm trying not to. I'm a one-trick pony. Fuck off.
Finish subtly sweet and spicy. Finish with a hint of vanilla, oak, white pepper, and ginger.
And ginger. I need to love you long time.
Wait.
Yes, so.
What do you think? This is the first time you've had Japanese whiskey, right?
Indeed it is. Now, I have to say, the first taste that I had of this, my reaction was, it's kind of scotchy.
It has the aftertaste of scotch.
It does. It has a bit of an after, but it is smooth.
That was my first tasting of Japanese whiskey. I took a sip, and I'm like, ooh.
Right?
Smooth.
Smooth.
No pain whatsoever. None. It just goes down, and you're like, ah.
Don't feel pain like two samurai.
Warm. It has all the effects of whiskey without the pain.
Warm like geisha.
Now we'll find out later on the show if somebody makes a mistake how smooth it really is if we have to do a shot.
Oh.
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 You're still losing on the shot count, by the way.
Right?
It's good. I like it.
You like it?
First taste of a Japanese whiskey.
This specific bottle is on the $50 range. It's not terrible.
Shit.
It's not terrible.
Some fancy shit. I put
because
my pinky out.
Some of the Japanese bottles, like the first one that I tried, which was at a cigar joint here in Elisa, that was set $85, $89
bottle. That price is entirely too high.
Yeah! I like it. Well played. Well played. I was well played. Yeah. Yes. So I'm really happy with this bottle.
Happy.
But I'm really happy with Crown Royal Black.
Crown Royal Black is pretty dope. I want to say, yeah, we had that on the show. Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, and it's like 20. Right now, you can go to Stater Bros and get it for $24.
Stater Bros.
Yeah.
Hey. I would say out of all the whiskeys that we've had on the show, I've actually, this show opened me up to new whiskeys because I was like, what the fuck do I pick up? Because I was usually the surveyor of new whiskey for the episodes. And Larceny, we all know, is probably one of my favorites.
Right. Not mine.
Elijah Craig. And what I found is that I just like to get punched in the face with bite. Like my wife.
So smooth is not your thing.
Yeah, no. I like a good, bitter, sharp whiskey. Like a bourbon that just
moonshine.
Like, no, moon. The problem is, okay, the only moonshine, legit moonshine that I've ever had is like that flavored crap that you get at like BevMo. Yeah, yeah, and that is not moonshine.
No, you want to drive to Kentucky and just get some just dirty ass fucking bourbon.
It's on the bucket list. That needs to go on the bucket list. I need to go to Kentucky and drink some fucking bathtub distilled moonshine.
Oh fuck.
Yes. And then breathe jet fuel for the next week.
Sounds like prison wine.
Dude, I've had
I've given it a shot before. One time I was in Spain and we were visiting this friends of my mom's and George's.
Was she hot?
No. No, they're old and married, and no, their daughter. Different story. But anywho, before I convict myself, shit. Yeah. So anywho, let's not incriminate beans in this whole thing. Back to the story. This is how we do a 7-hour show. They have a winery and they do wine, and their wine is delicious. It was good. It's not the one you've tasted. They don't import it. They don't bottle it. They just make it for them, their family and friends. That's
I like it.
Nice. But then with what's left over, they make moonshine.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, the moonshine out of wine.
Winey moonshine.
Yeah, it's clear. It's white. There's nothing to it. Oh, damn.
It's like just straight like
it fucking burns. It fucking kicks you in the teeth.
It burns.
Yeah.
It burns.
Of course, I was already like, you know, bottle and a half of wine deep. And they're like, would you like to have it? I'm like, yep. Ah. Would you like another one? I'm like, They're like, how are you still standing? I'm like,
I'm not.
Later on that night, I'm like, I'm standing.
I'm still standing?
Yeah. I didn't know.
Wow.
Yeah, that shit fucking kicked me in the ass.
Sounds like the Russian vodka story.
Kind of like
yeah,
that, yeah.
One of those just yeah, like, yeah. You should have some of this. Okay. Shit. And then like three shots later.
Yeah. They're like, oh, joke on the Mexican. All right. You think you can drink? I'm like, yeah, I can't. They were impressed that I had a second one. They're like, really?
Well, when you don't know,
yeah, I'm like, oh,
yeah, you give me a short window of opportunity. You're like, here's a
I'll
shot.
Make bad decisions. Yeah,
good
sure.
job. Here's another one.
Yeah.
Good job. You want a third one? What are you up to? Wait a second now.
Wait.
Yeah.
Like I think if I wasn't thinking, I could shoot myself in the head twice. Yeah.
Double trigger.
Yeah. Click. Click. Oh, they're like, bitch, just shot himself.
Careful,
twice.
There's a 15-second filter on Facebook. Yeah. You joke gonna, about it too much. They're gonna cut us off the air.
I'm Mark Zuckerberg. I am kidding. I would never do
just
that.
Just a joke.
Not gonna do that on Facebook or ever.
Just a joke.
For that matter, I don't even have a gun.
I got these guns right here. How you doing?
Anywho, how was your weekend?
My weekend was fan-fucking-tastic.
What you do?
So on Friday night, I was invited out to Le Rush Bar and Grill.
Le Rouge.
We're having a big band play that night. It's either that or hey. The bar was having a pretty decent sized band and turnout come for like a birthday party or whatever. So they were like, well,
what
we could
band?
Use Wayward Sons. It's a like classic rock meets like somewhat pop stuff. They'll cover a couple like just good ballads that everybody knows. But they're showmen. Like these guys dress up, they play the part. There's a guy in like tight gold spandex which I'm pretty sure
shit.
He stuffs a sock down his pants. It's like, I mean, that shit is tight.
You hope he does.
If he doesn't, I'm impressed. Is what I'm saying.
So was your wife.
So
like,
right,
damn.
She wasn't there. So she was watching the kids because I got to watch the front door. I was bouncing that night.
You were bouncing.
I was being a tough guy. So I literally stood around like this all night and was like, I need to see some ID. Can I help you out? Okay. Are you going to drive home? Okay. You guys drive safe now. Okay. Have a good day. That was literally what I did all night. And no joke.
What were you wearing? Were you wearing a
black? Yeah. Black on black. Ooh. Yeah. Just trying to
where'd
make sure.
Where'd you get that outfit? Like that's not.
That's so out of the norm for me, right?
Yeah. Like you're usually bright colors.
Yeah. I know. I'm a pretty colorful
dude.
Where'd
you get the black t-shirt from? I can't picture it.
Yeah.
I don't see it.
I know. It's pretty much what I'm wearing right now. minus the hat.
You took off the whiskey. You're like, yeah. Man, we don't want to have the whiskey.
It was a long sleeve because I knew it was going to be outside at night, so I wore a long sleeve. But there was a couple patrons that know me well, and they were like, "Man, you're really looking tough there with your arms crossed, standing by the front door." And I was like, "Move it right along, move it right along." So there, you know, the downside.
Did you get paid?
Oh yeah, I got paid.
Oh, okay. That's
good. I mean, that was kind of the gig. They were like, "Will you do this?" And I was like, "And is there money?" And they're like, "Yes, there's money." I was like, "Okay, cool, I'll do it." Otherwise, I would have
been. By the
way,
I got a text saying that you were bouncing. I'm like, bouncing?
He was thinking this.
Yeah.
Well, I was just bouncing.
That's exactly what I
pictured.
What
kind of crack were you taking?
Was it a typo?
It was not a typo.
Yeah.
So I hung out at the door all night and was hoping for some action, like at least crack somebody's.
Whoa,
I wanted to break somebody's skull open or remove somebody or break up a fight or do something. And
not a thing.
Not a fucking thing happened. Now, there were two events that did happen that were worth mentioning. They're notable.
Sure.
The guy whose birthday it was that was at the bar the night, he was actually the reason the band played that night because he like solicited them being there because he's buddies with his band.
Okay,
and they're a decent sized band. They bring in like a solid crowd. So on top of it being a busy night, it was also a birthday night for this guy. He's turning 50. His wife shows up. She's wearing a leather French maid outfit.
Oh.
What's up, listener?
Like
Andy?
Edie Beedy?
Itty bitty. Like, all she had to do was sneeze or bend over.
Where's my picture? Where's my picture?
I would not do that. That's rude, sir.
I'll show you later. So you'll show. Okay. He'll show me later.
So she had like this. It was a like a leathery tube top with like a little black tutu on.
Yeah, man.
That was like short as shit. I mean, the thing had to be like this big.
Fuck yeah.
And a typical like Newport OC, you know, mama. She and banging.
I like that.
She was handling. Everybody noticed her. She was doing all right.
I like that.
So he's with her all night, and they're up towards the dance floor in the middle of like the night, and they're, I can't remember what song they were doing, but like everybody was going nuts. Like it was a like big song. He's with his wife at the far end of the bar, leaning up against the bar, and he's got her straddled on him like this.
Oh shit.
And they're dancing and bouncing around. And did I tell you how old he was turning?
No.
50. Okay. So they're dancing and they're bouncing around like this, and lo and behold, he blows out his knee.
His knee gave out?
On the dance floor, while on his birthday, while his band was playing,
down.
And just ate it. He was literally sit feet up on the floor, just like, what happened? He swore up and down that somebody had kicked him in his knee. He blew it out so bad. He was like, somebody knocked out my knee. Somebody kicked out my knee.
Fuck.
And everybody around was like, there was nobody around him. He was just being a jackass, dancing with his wife like a retard, thinking he was 15 again. And
you're 50, bro.
You're 50. Not 15.
No. I couldn't do it right now, and I'm not 50.
Dude, so we pick the guy up. We take him into the kitchen, get some ice on his knee. His wife's there like, what do we do? Like, it hadn't swelled up or anything. What was cool is the guy was like some sort of sports enthusiast or whatever. So all the guys around him were like fitness, sports buffs, whatever. So they were like, Isaac, get a band. One guy ran to his car and had a knee band and all that shit.
Oh, wow.
He wasn't going to go
down. Another one was like, man up, pussy.
That's pretty much how he handled it. He was like, I've got this shit. He was like, I'm going to camp out back here. He's like, I'm not just shutting down my birthday party. So he kept the party going strong, but everybody kind of hung around him, whatever.
Sure.
So that was the biggest event of the night. The second was my boy. I'm not even going to say his name yet because that'll ruin the story. But finish the shift. I'm done.
Okay. Sure,
bar is closed out. Band has left. Birthday boy has hopped his way
up
to his car. They were done at like 11:45 to midnight, between there.
2-3 sets.
So it's like, man, they played all the way through.
Oh,
they
fuck.
Did not stop
they
for like
stop?
3 hours straight. Super impressive band. Like,
that's
impressive. They were on it. It was fucking awesome. So
they were on it like a bonnet.
These guys, I don't know whoever would be on it like a bonnet.
He just
rhymed. Yeah, okay. So
you should be impressed. I could rhyme.
I am. You did rhyme. That's true.
Yeah,
true.
Yeah.
We never had a rap battle.
No.
I'm kind of saddened by this.
Well, you're going to have to come back one day. I'm going to have to put this back together.
I'll be back. So
I'm not sure what to do with the room yet.
I can think of a few things. You got all this lighting and some cameras.
Porn, just baby.
Saying,
porn.
Just saying.
What was the name of that girl in the outfit?
I'm not going to mention her name on the air.
Well, can you give me her phone number? I need to make a living.
867-5309. That might have been the song that was playing, actually.
Chat roulette. Chatbait.
Chatbait? Is that what it is?
Chatterbait?
I don't know.
It's
I don't care
about
that shit.
Yeah.
It's not my thing. That's your thing.
Okay.
Just saying.
All right. Sally's not watching. It's all right.
I'm closing out the shift.
Uh-huh.
I'm done making sure everything's like busting. Sure. Tables are done, helping out the servers. And it's time for me to have a drink. It's late.
Fucking
wife gave me a hall pass. She's like, I know you're going to hang out
after. Whoa.
Yeah. Sally
gave
me a hall
pass.
A hall pass.
You know what a hall pass is, right?
No. No, not that kind of hole. No, 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 no,
no.
Otherwise, I would be saying hi to the guys.
I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa.
It wasn't that kind of hole.
Sally give you what? Oh, okay, okay.
No, 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 no.
Oh, okay, okay.
She was just like, if you're going to like hang out, they just don't like get too crazy and drink too much
she
and not
said,
be able
have
to get
fun.
Home. Yeah, she was like, have
okay.
fun. So
that should matter. Like,
I go to order my first drink at the bar. And mm-hmm. as I'm walking up to the bar, still in bouncer mode, like kind of like, you know, making sure that everything's taken care of. There is a dude.
Come on, give me bouncer. Bouncer look.
I can't do the microphones too close, but this is bouncer mode. That's it. That's all I got. So wait, I gotta put both hands under the muscles and pump them up a little bit. Like so the Ash and Matt are laughing over the hall pass. Yes,
yeah,
it was not
exactly.
That,
I'm
not
like,
that kind of hall pass.
I'm like, no, I think
my hall pass and your hall pass are two completely different things. I don't know how many hall passes you got. I ain't ever received that kind of hall pass.
Have you seen the movie Hall Pass?
Is that a movie? Is that a thing?
Yeah, oh, it's a comedy.
That. Is that where it comes from? Is that movie?
No, that's not where it comes from. No. It was, yeah. But, yeah.
Shit. I'm like, you, the movie Hall
you
Pass.
Say Hall Pass, I'm thinking you can fuck another girl. All right. Way to go, Sally.
Wasn't that going to Hall Pass?
Okay.
Not to mention, that's dirty. So, moving right along. This guy's sure, passed sure. out. He's got his head down.
Uh-oh.
So, I'm like, dude.
On the bar.
Yeah, on the bar. Like, he's sitting at the bar, on the bar, sleeping on the bar. Now, the one thing that we know is if you got a red mark on your hand, it means that you came from the bar next door because they're 18 and over because they're a pool hall.
Oh, okay.
So, they cater to, and like, the younger demographic. So, they make sure they mark you if you're 21. So, what happens is after hours or when the people have had too much, they come over to our bar and try and squeeze in a couple more rounds.
Sure.
And we're like, no.
You just got cut off,
you
bitch.
You fucked up. So, dude was at the bar, passed out on the bar.
Sure, sure.
I'm like, all right, he needs to check out. I told the bartender, I was like, close this guy out. I'll make sure he gets an Uber. And I like nudge him on the shoulder and I'm like, bro, it's time to get an Uber. He's like, no, dude, did you see it? Did I see what? Did you see it? It was amazing. Little Asian dude. And I was like, no, I don't know what you're talking about. And I looked at the bartender and I was like, what the hell are you talking about? He's like, I have no idea. He's like, I don't know. He's like, it was, I can't believe you see. I mean, oh my God. And I'm like, all right.
Love drunk people.
Dude, he was fucked up. Like, gone. So I told him, I was like, I tell you what, if I can guess your name, you've got to take an Uber home. I was like, if I can guess your name, you're going to take an Uber home. And he was like, come on. Like, just not having it. He was like, you're not going to guess my name.
All right.
Little does he know, I looked at his credit card when the bartender turned in his bill. So I'm like, I'm thinking it starts with an A.
I see an A. Ooh.
And he was all, his eyes got really big and he was like, how the fuck? Like, he was legitimately like, what? And I was like,
fucking with drunk
starts
people.
Starts with an A and he backs up and he's like, my name's Roy, dude. And I knew his name wasn't Roy. And I was like, your name's not Roy, bro. And he was like, gives me that like suspicious. And I was like, Andrew? His head fucking explodes. He loses his mind. He's like, no way. Oh, like, dude's dancing on his bar stool. Like, cannot fucking believe that I guessed his name. And I'm like, I bet's a bet, homeboy. It's time to go.
The fuck
and,
yeah.
he owned up. He was like, okay. Right. Now,
to this day, he's like, there was this bouncer. Holy shit.
Know.
He's a fucking magician. David Blaine, eat your heart out.
So I took him outside. Then it turns into him like arguing with me about his Second Amendment rights and how he distributes cannabis or something like that.
What does Second Amendment have to do with
the
cannabis?
The right to bear arms. I have no idea.
I know. What does that
he's
have to do
up.
With cannabis?
He's fucked up. Who cares?
Okay.
So he started going and I was just like, uh-huh. So I was like, pull your phone out, order your Uber. And so he'd like, he'd inch it and he'd be like, wait. And I was like, no. Like 10
I'm sorry,
minutes
you said,
of this.
What?
No. Pull the phone out now.
Pick it up.
Get the Uber.
You pick it up.
You put it down. So he finally, he works his phone out of his pocket.
Sure.
And I noticed that he does unlock it. And the second he unlocks it while he's arguing with me about his Second Amendment rights and cannabis, I pull his phone from him. I'm like, Uber, here and home and boom. Okay, you're good. And then the car pulls up and I was like, dude, I think that's your Uber. And he's like, I ordered an Uber.
Yes, you did.
I'm a fucking magician to this guy. He thinks I'm a goddamn wizard.
So, David Copperfield, eat your heart out.
I walk up to the car and there's like this crouchy old Asian
crouchy
man
old
sitting
man.
In the front seat.
Yeah.
And he just cracks his window because here comes this guy with this drunken fool.
Sure.
And I'm all, are you here to pick up Andrew? And he's like, yes. And I was like, okay. I open the back
Andrew.
Door. Andrew like falls into the car.
Oh, shit.
It's like, hey. And I was like,
kapoosh.
I hand him his phone and then I put my hand down. I'm like, this is Andrew. He needs to go home.
I'm sorry.
I didn't say I was sorry. I just shut the door and walked away, but I was really
sorry. He's going to puke in your car.
He was fucked up. But that's it. That's all I had for the whole night. It was just like a drunk dude and some guy that blew out his knee.
You asked me to come over, and I almost did. Mm. So I went to Shmopa. I said I was going to start a Shmopa because it was a buddy of mine's birthday party. One of the guys I hang out with at Shmopa.
Hey, bro. Happy birthday.
And he invited this person. We'll call him Kevin.
Kevin.
Because that's his name.
He's fucked up. You're not supposed to do that. Take a shot.
So Kevin was there. And Kevin's a baller.
He's the boss.
I didn't know that. So I learned he's a baller.
All right. How did you learn this?
We're having, you know, it's a birthday, but we all met at the bar. So we didn't get a table or anything. We're hanging out at the bar, and we have like, shit, about 10 seats at the bar. Mm. That's our party, and it's about 12 to 15 people hanging out, just having fun, running around, doing our thing. We're having a good time. And this guy is like, shots of, I forget what it is. It was Cuervo like 1942. Nice. It comes in this fancy-ass bottle. He ordered 12 shots for the group. They were chilled. The first one tasted good. I'm like, I was impressed because I'm not a tequila person. I'm like,
no, you're not.
I didn't shoot it. I sipped it, and most people sipped it because it's a $25 to $30 shot. Ouch. So we're sipping.
I'm like, he's a baller.
Yeah. So we're sipping. I'm like, okay, that's good. But I was already on a martini, so I'm like, all right.
Gotta take your time.
10 minutes later, kablow.
Another round
shows up. I'm like, fuck. I'll sip it. It's okay. I got me some dinner because I'm like, ooh. I got a steak. I got a fucking filet mignon and some mushrooms and all that good stuff. I'm like, I need to build a base so I can get in there.
To build some tolerance.
Would you like some bread? I'm like, uh-huh.
Yeah, peace. Uh-huh. I want all the bread.
Yeah, I need to soak it up.
Give me bread now.
And as I'm enjoying my second martini, yet another round.
Triple threat.
Shows up. Well, I'm like,
damn, bro, that's like $75 in shots.
I cheered per person. Ouch. I cheered. Wow. And then I gave my shot to the bartender.
You're like, and here you go.
There, evidently, I talked to the bartender the next day, but Sunday. The bartender took 4 shots from us.
Oh, no.
4 people went, fuck no. And he's like, fuck yeah. That shit is expensive. That's a happy bartender. Yeah, and I actually saw the guy paying the bill, his tab.
Did you see it?
Yeah.
Oh, what was it?
700.
Oh.
7 something. It was like 720 something.
For drinks?
Yeah.
Now, and it was his brother's birthday?
No. Just a friend.
Wow. That's a good friend.
And he tipped on top of that. Proper.
So my birthday's tomorrow.
It was just under $1,000. I'm like, fuck me.
That's a good guy right there. Dude, throwing down, he also tipped politely.
Yes.
That's
he left $200. I'm like,
I'm going to leave my address.
All it was shots.
And I'm going to bartend on a certain night at La Roche. And you better show up. I'll give you all the shots you want.
Yeah, it was amazing. I'm like, fuck. Nice. Yeah, I passed by when he got the check. I'm like, because I wanted to see how much it was. I'm like, oh, yike.
Now, I don't know if this is a thing, but do you walk into a bar and look at the top shelf and just kind of gauge like what kind of bar it is based off of the top shelf? I'm not a bar faring person. So.
But what?
Bar faring? Fearing? Faring? Is that right? Faring? Faring?
What are you trying to say?
When I say I go to bars often, I don't. I'm fucking married with kids. So.
Yeah, but you go to a bar.
I go to a bar.
Oh, okay.
But I'm saying like when you go out, you like kind of gauge whether or not.
For me, it's usually the same. I go to the same bar. I go to Shmopa all the time.
Okay.
If
and they're upper end or not higher end, but they're like
they like to charge more.
They charge more. Yeah. But do they have more stuff on the top shelf than other places? Like if you ask for something hoity-toity,
I would like to have a Macallan.
Everybody has a Macallan. I'm probably pulling Macallan out of my fucking car right now. I couldn't. I'm lying. I couldn't.
I could add the pizza boy to deliver some. You know, they have some stuff. Like it's not like fancy shit. They don't have like upper echelon.
Sure.
Like for example, a stadium next door, which is a lower place, has better liquor. Mm. Funny enough, cheaper.
But you don't go there.
The cigar bar where I tried my first shot of Japanese whiskey.
Fight?
That is like $90 for a fucking bottle.
Height? Prices?
Those bitches have no idea what they're serving. I pay $5 for a shot.
Are you kidding me?
I'm not kidding.
What?
They're fucking idiots.
Why are we drinking here? Let's do the show over there. It's cheaper.
Yes, I know. Yeah, I got there, and a buddy of mine's like, get the Japanese whiskey. They have no idea what the fuck they're doing. I'm like, nice. I'll take the Japanese whiskey. I'm like,
well, bam, bam, bam.
Went to pay. I'm like, $5. Like, that's a $90 bottle. They have no idea what they're doing. Like,
oh, fucking dope.
Fucking yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know how they're in business still. I know how they're in business. They serve alcohol to underage crowd. Oh, yeah. Oh, they're about to get shut
down.
That's
where you take all your girlfriends. They're gonna I get it.
They're going to get shut down hard.
Yeah, it happens.
But every time I go there, well, I made a deal with myself.
No more cigar bar.
No more cigar bar.
Yeah.
Because I used to do some Fridays and Saturdays, I used to do the trifecta. Schmopa, stadium, cigar bar.
The only time that I've ever heard of you getting into an altercation was where?
Cigar bar.
Yeah.
Yes.
Seems like that's not your jam.
I'm like, no, I made a deal with myself. No more cigar bar, so I don't go there anymore. Even though they have cheap drinks. But this is a third bar. I'm like, I don't need that.
Nope.
So now, and I kind of don't like stadium either. So now I'm just kind of hanging out at Schmopa.
Schmopa.
They don't charge much for, like, if it's just a pour, it's not bad. It's when they do a martini.
The cocktails, when they actually start mixing stuff up.
Right. Yeah. Once you add the shaking, that's
when their plates are a little high, too. They're good. They're really well made.
There's some that, like, if you happy hour, they have, like, mussels and stuff like that. $10.
I love mussels.
Yeah. $10 for.
I actually got my wife to eat a mussel for the first time ever in her life.
Really?
With last weekend or the weekend prior. And mussels are fishy. It's a fishy food.
I love them.
Yeah, I'm down. I like fishy
Schmopa
food.
Schmopa has mussels scampi, and you can add pasta to them. And then they give you bread.
So nice.
You can soak that shit.
That was kind of what I had. Where did I go? Two Forks. Or Four Forks or whatever the hell it's called. Next to
Two Forks.
Bacchus. There's a place next to Bacchus, like something Two Forks or Four Forks or whatever.
Not next to it, across the way,
yeah,
right?
Across the street.
Across the parking lot. Yeah, I've been there.
They have like a seafood like soupy thing that like, so my wife was laughing her ass off at me because I had one drink while we were over there. And my face was like lit up red. And she's like, what the hell's wrong with you? And I'm like, I'm not going to lie. The soup was kind of spicy. And she was like, you puss. Are you serious? Like, it wasn't the drink at all.
The soup was
kind of
spicy.
I get red like super like quick.
What did listener Andy just say?
Listener Andy said, didn't know OU mussels had fishy taste.
Hold on a little bit.
Wait. No, you actually have to have muscles.
Oh!
Sick burn!
Bitch!
Hey! So, yeah, she had a muscle over there.
Did she like it?
No. She ate it. I mean, she finished it, but it was one of these.
What the fuck is that?
I
love muscles. So, at Schmopa, on a happy hour menu, before 6:30, you can get muscles, a plate of muscles, for $10.
I've been paying my personal trainer way too much.
with the scampi sauce. So good.
Yum.
If you do it right, like if you get a beer instead of
a cocktail or whatever.
I think last time I paid like $30.
It's not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah. Figure for a couple drinks and
three beers and some food, $30.
Not bad.
There's days when I leave there and it's $100, but there's days when it's
easy to blow money when you're drinking,
right?
Because the second that you're like, I feel good, I'm not worried about tomorrow,
I'll take a martini,
and then you wake up tomorrow, and you're like, I'm an idiot. I was a bad idea. I shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
Listener Andy says she didn't gag. I'm a little shocked. Laugh out loud. I don't recall her gagging. She handled it like a champ. Like, I'm not going to lie. She did good.
That is the biggest thing she's had in her mouth in a long time.
That's hurtful. How dare you?
That's hurtful. So that was my weekend. Rocket, I believe it's time to see what we have. Not this week. Last time in the news. Tell us about it, Rocket.
Stoner mice? Question mark.
I don't know.
Buenos Aires, Argentina, about 13,000 pounds of bud were supposed to be in storage, but a recent police inspection revealed 1,000 pounds were missing.
Ooh.
Javier Specia, the city's former police commissioner, was ordered to explain the shortfall to a judge. He and three subordinates told the skeptical jurist the missing marijuana must have been eaten by mice. Buenos sure. Aires University experts have explained that mice wouldn't mistake the drug for food, and that if a large group of mice had eaten it, a lot of corpses would have been found in the warehouse.
No kidding.
All eight officers were dismissed from their jobs and will testify in front of the judge on May 4th. The judges will then decide if the drugs are missing due to expedience or negligence.
Oh, I wonder which one it is.
I don't think the mice are getting high. Three high mice.
So
see how they don't run?
I do have a question, though.
See how they crawl?
I didn't think you could die from marijuana overdose.
Well, if you eat like
a shit ton
of herb, I mean, it's just like, you could. I'm sure if they ate something that they weren't supposed to, like 3 pounds of
bud. I freaked out one time.
Up against the wall, panting.
No, that wasn't me.
That wasn't me.
That
wasn't me. Today in history, would you like to hear?
Please tell us about
1906, the great San Francisco earthquake erupted. In 2012, Dick Clark, host of American Bandstand in New York's Rockin' Eve, he died.
And
in 2018, the world's greatest podcast come to an end.
Damn!
Sad but true. Can I get a...
Actually, I got your fanfare.
Oh, you got me fanfare. I'll take it.
Done.
It's one of those like, are we there yet?
So, with that rocket, if somebody wants to buy something fun from our, at this point, it would be a vintage store.
Catch up. We're having a closeout sale. Yeah. Beansandrockets.com.
I was going to say, where can they go?
They can go to www. No store. Damn. Last episode. Number 80. Still managed to fuck it up. Wait for it. Store.beansandrocket.com.
Shop and support the show. Go to store.beansandrocket.com or use the link at the bottom of any of our pages.
What?
Get your Beans and Rocket gear and support the show. Store.beansandrocket.com.
And if you love the hat, it's a sexy hat. You know that hat is one of one, right?
I do.
Nobody ever can get that hat.
Not this hat.
Not that hat.
You know why? Because it's on my head, motherfucker.
We have red available on the website.
Mm-hmm. But that's not, your jam. You gotta get one.
Not black. I don't do hats though.
I know, it's that hair.
I have a T-shirt.
You do.
I have a Beans and Rocket T-shirt. One.
That's cool. Yeah. Yeah. You should get the hat.
Yeah, I don't.
We could be like frenzies.
Twinsies.
Twinsies.
Frenzies.
I don't know. I'm not hip to this like new age talk and shit. Getting old. Fuck.
Now with that, if they don't want to buy anything from our store, but they still want to support the show that's vintage at this point, how can they do that?
Well, what you need to do is you need to go to www.beansandrocket.com. Scroll down to the bottom. Make sure your ad blocker's turned off because that kind of gets in the way.
There you go.
Shop Amazon and support the show at the same time. If you use Amazon to do your shopping, do us a favor and go to beansandrocket.com, scroll down to the bottom of any of our pages, and click on the Amazon link. Same Amazon service, same Amazon price, but you support the show at the same time.
Rocket!
Hi.
You brought something to the show. Tell us about it. You have someone near and dear to your heart that is about to wreck the streets of Orange County.
I hope to God not. So yes, I am the proud parent.
Sure, and nervous.
extremely nervous. Extremely nervous parent of a recently licensed driver.
Fuck me.
God save us all.
Yeah.
Now,
true that.
I will say this. My daughter, I don't think we have a nickname for her on the show, so I'll just say my daughter. She got her
You've said her name
before. Yeah, I've said her name. I don't care. So she got her driver's license yesterday. She studied for this thing like a fucking champ.
Okay, so have they changed it much? Is it still on paper? Is it?
Yeah.
So,
it's like a touchscreen quiz.
Okay, so they've
changed. You exactly what you got wrong for what you got wrong, and then you get your passing or not passing grade. So there's that part, but that's what you get when you take the permit. You don't have to take a written test now when you go to do the driver's test.
Right, you got
to
do the
wheel. I had to do it twice. I had to take a written test for my permit. I had to take a written test for my damn driver's license. What the fuck?
Little quick thing of information for you is I took my written test.
Uh-huh.
And the girl, because you can only miss like 3 questions in California, something like that.
California.
So I turned it. At the time, it was a paper, and the person actually like graded it.
Uh-huh.
So give her my paper. She's like, yeah, no. And got to the last question. She's like, on the last one, did you mean C instead of D? I'm like, yes, I did. Yes, I did. I'm sorry. Yes, I did. She's like, I thought so.
Yeah.
Pass. I'm like, oh.
Nice.
Holy shit.
So to be 100% honest, I took my written test 2 times and my driving test 3. Now, to be fair, my driving test I had to take at least 2 times because I took one up in Alaska, failed it the first time.
Oh, shit.
I had to take it a second time. And then I had to take one when I moved down here to California. I'm not sure why at the time, but it might have been because I was a newer driver.
The laws don't apply?
Maybe.
Like, if encountered by a deer, you're like, California.
What's
doesn't
a fucking deer? We're talking about a moose.
If encountered by a moose.
Yeah. If
a moose is mounting a bear, what should you do on the highway?
I'm going to say this right now.
Yeah.
Because I'm 100% confident that the driving standards in Alaska are much higher than they are down in California.
Well, you have to know how to drive in the snow.
Okay. You guys have a drizzle of fucking rain down here, and everybody goes, oh, it's raining, what is it? And it's like everybody loses their shit and can't do a thing. They're flying off the fucking freeway into the water off of PCH.
I think I've shared this before. When I've been to Anchorage once on a week-long trip, and I landed, got my rental, and the guy's like, would you like the insurance? You know, they always try to sell you the insurance. I'm like,
I don't need that shit.
So if I wreck the car, I get a new one? He's like, yes, that's covered by the insurance. I'm like, you saw my driver's license, right? I'm from California. I've never seen snow. He's like,
give me the insurance.
Yeah, he's like, I'm like, sign me up for that shit. He's like,
fuck. Basically, without that, he was off.
Fuck me. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nobody prepared him for that. Fuck yeah, sign me up for that. I'm going to wreck your car.
Did you ever see that? I think it was in a Jackass movie where they did a rental car and it came back like spray painted. That's exactly what would have happened. Like you would come back and like, I don't know.
I saw that. Yes.
I got it like this.
I'm like, I don't know.
I left it alone for 5 minutes. I was at Walmart and shit happened.
I know. That's all they had, by the way. Because I needed something, you know, deodorant. I forgot. I always.
Wait. You went from downtown to Walmart?
Yeah. That's not that far.
Well, not for you. For people from Alaska or Anchorage. Like, it's a trek.
Okay, so quick 2 stories. Is one day, they're like, oh, what'd you do yesterday? I'm like, I took a drive. They're like, did you get lost? I'm like, how? your town is this big.
You live in a fucking village. I'm like, do you not get that?
I'm like, your town is this big. Like, no, I didn't
get lost.
I'm like, no, I came from Southern California, bitch. I'm like,
that's really funny.
You could drive from San Diego to San Francisco and see shit. I'm like, no, fuck that's you. Really funny. I'm like, no. And then the second one at the hotel, I always, whenever I travel, I always forget something. I don't know why.
It's a thing.
Always forget something. Toothbrush, you know, you name it. I'm like, oh, you guys have a Target. And then he's like, what?
Fred Meyers.
Like, so what? And like, you know, where you can get like deodorant, like you can get everything from deodorant to like blankets and like, oh, Walmart. I'm like,
fuck yeah. Let's
yes.
Go. I'll take it.
That's it. And like, well, go that way. I'm like, all right. So I drove there and, but.
15, 20 minutes?
Yeah, about.
That's the longest drive you will make in the city.
I know.
So, which is funny because when I moved down here, 45 minutes to work. You're and like, I was like, what the hell is this? I was so mad.
How big is this town?
Like, I was like, I went 3 cities to get to work? Like, what the fuck? Like, yeah, no, it would up back home. Like, okay, so my first vacation.
But fun fact, Anaheim, just the city of Anaheim, has more residents than the entire state of Anchorage.
Oh, I'm aware.
I'm sorry, the entire state of Alaska. Yes. Yeah, sorry.
And Alaska is two-thirds the size of the entire US. Lower 48. Yeah, what?
Yeah, that's what when they're like, did you get lost? I'm like, how?
Yeah. Yeah.
There's two streets.
So the city of Anchorage, I might be misquoting this, but I think they take out the
what
military.
What part of Anchorage were you in?
I was all over. I went to four different
because
elementary schools.
Because funny enough, you know where I was.
Oh, yeah. I know. Exactly. Yeah. I know the city.
Alaska, USA. And
I could go back.
The Applebee's.
And know exactly where I am. No problem. I say this, but watch me go back and be like, where the fuck am I? But I went to four different junior highs or elementary schools.
We should take a trip. It'd be fun.
Two different middle schools.
Oh, shit.
Three different high schools. And worked at a bunch of different like restaurants and stuff as I was growing up.
I went to Hooters.
Okay, so let's be fair here. An Alaskan 10 is like a California 4.
Yeah. At best. I'm like, whoa!
At best.
Yeah, I went there. I'm like, whoa!
There is definitely and what's funny is there's an actual like statistic figure that's been proven or whatever that there is one guy to every eight girls in Alaska. I don't know what the hell is going on with the female chromosome up in the AK, but that's a lot of females.
Yeah, well, I kind of have
Let's hear it. Let's hear it. I know where this is going.
Yes.
Yeah, I know.
Where everybody has an extra chromosome.
Squeal, piggy. Squeal.
Those are pretty teeth.
This is actually one of the first songs I learned.
Shocking.
Yeah. So
I thought it was the national anthem.
The entire like city itself, I think, is 16 by 22 miles.
Is that it?
That's it.
Damn.
There's a military base that accounts for extra, but I don't think that's included. Yeah, well, you wouldn't.
Yeah,
but there's that military base is fucking scary.
It's the last thing you see. Yeah. Yeah. All right, it makes sense.
I was actually born on the military base. It was the Air Force base.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Okay. Yep.
My dad was Army, but I was born on Elmendorf Air Force Base. Okay. And there is some crazy shit on that base.
I'm sure.
Some cool stuff. There, if you look at it from a satellite, there's this big radar beacon thing that you launch a new dude, it's cool.
I'm sure you can.
There's
and
probably
one
there.
And I'm sure they're pointed west.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty sure. Actually, you could just carry it across a bridge.
Yeah. Can you say Moscow?
Yeah.
Can you carry it across
sure.
You can see it from – you can see it in Russia from your backyard.
Oh, yeah. That's what I've been told anyways. Yeah.
So, anywho, back to your point of driving.
Moving right along. Yes. My daughter got her driver's license.
She is how old right now?
She is 16.
On the dot or
– Well, no. She'll be 17 in October.
Okay. So 16 and 3/4.
Yeah.
Sure.
Then. So 16 and a half.
Sure, sure.
So she gets her license yesterday, and
I saw a
promised
picture
her
of it on Facebook.
Yeah, I was proud of her.
She looked happy.
And I was happy too. She passed her test. She actually had one of the hardest instructors that are apparently in that DMV. I won't go into how she knows that, but YouTube and Google and all that, like, you can't hide anything anymore. Like,
sure,
people
sure.
post and write about everything. So she passed her course. She got her license. We're solid. And the first thing she asked, she's like, "Can I drive home from school?" Because I had to take her back to school after her
Makes
test.
Sense.
And I was like, "Sure." Little did I remember that she's in a later class for school on Tuesdays.
Okay.
Which means she gets out at 5:15. Now she goes to school in Irvine, which is city away from where we live, which means we're taking the freeway. And the freeway happens to be the largest and most densely populated freeway. No, not just the 5, it's the Y. The Y,
where the 5 and the 405 meet.
I don't know if you
have to cross it. Yeah.
I don't know if you know this, but the Y is 27 lanes across.
Is that what's emerging?
And is literally, when you put all the lanes together,
right.
It's 27 lanes across, and it is the largest freeway like junction in the world. And my daughter, on her first day of having her license, wants to drive home.
You're like,
so me not considering the repercussions of my decision, I said, "Yeah, no, sure. I promised you would."
Sure,
so I let her get in the driver's seat, and we get on the freeway. And I'm like, the second we get on the freeway,
you're like, "Uh-oh,
fuck! It's 5 o'clock at the Y.
Yeah,
this is gonna suck." And you don't take into like
you're like
how
switch.
How much you know about the freeway and people being assholes
and cutting
you off and like just stop and go traffic and it being really busy and distractions everywhere. On top of that, you being 16 and only having your driver's license
for
3 fucking hours. So, needless to say, my daughter was laughing at me because I was pressed back.
You
into
were
this.
Stressed out
I
more
was,
than she
I
was.
I have never been stressed with her driving, but this was one of those moments where I was like, I'm going to die. I did not know.
Which car was this?
It was my truck.
Okay, well, yeah, at least
we were protected, but it was still a matter of like,
at least you weren't in a smart car.
Yeah, no, for sure. For sure. But it was definitely right. One of those moments where I was like, oh, this is going to suck. This
so
is
which
gonna
one
be
is her
awful.
Car?
What's that?
Which one is her car?
I want to give her the truck, but she has told me that she actually wants to get her own car. So she's saving up and she's going to do the adult thing and purchase her own vehicle.
That's very
and
adult of her.
It is. I'm proud of the responsible youth that I've brought up. Now, my two boys, on the other hand, I'll probably end up carrying them till they fucking retire. We'll see. So she's like, no, she wants to get her own vehicle and whatever. So I'm like, okay, so I'm going to help her shop around and whatnot. Sure. But fuck, man, it's terrifying. Like, I got a kid that is on the road legally doing, like, you know, her thing, going places and stuff.
She got you home that day, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, my birthday's tomorrow. She's going to drive me home tomorrow, too.
And maybe today.
Possibly. Yo, can I get an Uber? You know what I'm saying?
True. What is it that your wife said? Yeah, Sally said what?
Yeah, my wife said, I know it's your birthday tomorrow, and this is your last episode. It's a big episode.
True.
So don't come home drunk.
Do we need to order pizza?
Pizza. Ooh, pizza sounds pizza like a good, good idea. Just okay. In general.
We'll order at 8 o'clock.
I like
so,
it.
So it gets here, it's and good plan. We'll be good. Yeah,
it's a good plan. I like your style. So my wife's like, if you need me to pack the kids in the car and come pick you up in the minivan because you were too fucked up to get home,
I get it.
I will take care of you. And I was like, oh, you're so sweet.
Way to go, Sally.
I'm like, she knows me so well.
You're like, yeah, I'm going to be fucked up.
I'll be good. I'm not going to be too bad.
Well, not if we're going to have some pizza, but we've killed half a bottle.
Not really. I mean, we've still got some sitting in the glass. Oh, that's the problem.
That's the problem. There you go. So.
Moving right
along. Are you comfortable with her driving?
My daughter? Yeah. I
now that you saw her on the Y, because I know. Big freeway merging with big freeway.
And a lot of assholes. The biggest problem that I have with her being on the road, right, is there's people out there that just don't know if it's a new driver or not. They don't care. They're just on the road because it's their road. They're going to drive it. So there's moments where you get cut off and stuff that she hasn't quite adjusted to.
You'll get used to it.
Yeah, and you do. It takes time. But no joke, I moved down here from California or from Alaska,
it's an adjustment.
My first time on the freeway, I would get cramps in my ass from the tension of like, what is going on? Why are people doing this? Like, I thought it was like something about like the way I was driving. No. People drive like assholes out here. It's insane.
But that's the way you drive, right?
Yeah. It really is. If you go to any other state, I'm pretty sure any other state, they don't drive like this here. Like, people are fucking nuts out in California.
I dare you to go to Mexico City.
Oh, really? Okay. I said state. I didn't say countries. You go to other countries,
fuck me.
When the laws are there is no driving rules, then it's
even when
to
I go to Cancun, like, you know, I go to Cancun on vacation and I'm like, well, A, you're like, where the fuck's the seatbelt? They're like, no, we cut that
what
off.
What seatbelt?
Yeah. I'm like,
airbags?
And this guy's like crossing the road on the other side. I'm like,
dude, you just ran that red light. What red light?
Red light? Yeah.
Look ahead.
Never mind. Yeah. Holy shit. It's scary as fuck. I'm like, I survived. Okay, thank you. I'll walk from here on. Yeah, I'll walk back to the airport. Thanks.
Tonga, third world Tonga. Country. There ain't a goddamn stop sign in the entire freaking island.
Good luck, everybody else.
The van that we got in that took us from the airport to the peninsula where we got on the little dinghy boat that might have had a hole in it that took us to the island. This is what I'm talking about, my honeymoon.
Mm-hmm.
It was layered in CDs to fill in the holes. Uh-huh.
That's to fill in the holes.
And then busted up. Yeah.
But at least it's fancy looking.
When he hit the brakes, the back seat shifted forward. Yeah.
Okay, so I was in Paris. Yes.
This one-upness that's happening right now.
No. It's not a one-upness, but I was in Paris with my ex-wife, and we were at the Arch of Triomphe.
The Arch of what?
Triomphe.
Triomphe.
It is the biggest motherfucking roundabout I've ever seen.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. I've seen this online.
It's about 6 to 8 streets coming in.
Yep.
And everybody's
it's like
just,
donuts on donuts on donuts on donuts.
Picture the Y. If the Y
was just a bunch of fucking circles.
Was a roundabout. It is just eight streets coming in at this massive sculpture, and they're just all going around.
What do you do?
And we were having lunch, and I'm like, oh, sit down. We're having lunch. I'm like, we're going to see an accident. I don't know how these French people know how to navigate that thing, because there was cars coming in fast, and I saw a Vespa coming in. I'm like, oh, he's dead.
I'm like, what?
We were taking bets. Like, oh, that guy's. How the fuck did he make it?
He's alive.
What the fuck? Yeah.
Like, Jesus.
Yeah. I don't know how to navigate that shit, but you see close calls coming in every single minute.
That's amazing.
I couldn't drive that shit. I drive in California, but I couldn't. Yeah, I'm like, that shit, that's expert level. You know what's funny is
the French probably wouldn't be able to drive here, because we drive exceptionally fast out here. So I got excited when I came down here and I got to attend Disneyland and ride the roller coasters. And my dad at the time during that time told me, he was like, you do realize we're doing 110 on the freeway right now.
Like, holy shit.
And I was like, what? He was like, we're just getting on the freeway. But he was purposely putting the pedal to the metal.
Like, holy shit.
You don't take into consideration like how fast you're actually going.
65 is the minimum.
That's kind of like a bar.
Yeah, you're going 65. If you're going 65 on the freeway, people are going to flip you off.
Yep.
Yeah. Fuck that noise. Yeah. So
it probably happened to my daughter while she was on the freeway yesterday.
One time I drove, a couple times I've driven a Twinkie's car. Hmm. She drives in the city. She's not a freeway person. She doesn't go far away. She likes to stay in town.
Keeps local.
But a few times I've driven her car and she looks over, she's like, oh! Betty, that's what she calls her car. She's like, Betty has never gone 85.
Oh.
Well, we're going to...
Calm down, Betty. We're going to get through this.
Yeah, I'm like, well, she's a German car, so we're going to open her up a little bit. I'm like, she was born for the Autobahn. This bitch can do 120. Fucking hey. Whenever I get a new car, I like to test the car. I want to see what she can do. And I usually take her out to Vegas. On my way to Vegas, I like to see. There's this spot in Vegas.
I know
on the
exactly
way
which one
it
you're talking
perfect.
About. Right
it
after Zizix coming around the hill.
It comes down, and then you can see everything. I'm like,
that's where all the cops like to hang out, because everybody knows that spot.
Well, you can see the cops a mile away.
Which is why they'll never pull you over.
Yeah, I'm like, okay. And when I don't see anybody, I'm like, let's do this. And I think I mentioned this on the show before. 145 on the MR2.
Nice.
120 on a... Civic.
115 89 Bronco 2.
Holy shit.
And a Bronco.
A Bronco?
Yes, and a Bronco. It a Bronco? Hey?
That's scary as fuck.
It was fantastic. I was terrified. I jumped railroad tracks doing it. Yeah, not a lot, but I mean, I got a little bit of air.
Fuck me.
Yeah, I was proud of myself. It was good. And I almost died, but I didn't.
Yeah, I know.
I'm still here, bitches.
Yeah, looking back, I'm like, I went how fast on a Honda Civic? And by the way, when I'm talking a Honda Civic, I got the DX, not the EX or anything. Is it the DX with tires?
We're talking base model.
Yeah. Tires were yay wide.
They look like spares.
Yeah. Like, if you look at the tires on my MR2, the back tires, they're like a fucking brick. They're the size of a fucking couch. Not on the Honda Civic. Yeah, no. The Honda Civic, I'm amazed that I'm alive. In the MR2, I'm like, oh, yeah, it's fine. Yeah, yeah, sure. They're like big-ass tires. Yeah, the Civic, I'm sure they were a little wobbly.
A little wobbly. You just went Irish there. I've never heard you sound like that before. You got a little wobbly. That's awesome.
Yeah, I'm like, whoo.
Yeah, I think the stupidest shit that I've done has all happened in my old Bronco. Like, I've done some
in California.
Dumps. Oh yeah, for sure. Getting on the 5 freeway from Jamboree.
By the way, this is a small Bronco, not the OJ.
No, this is not the OJ Bronco. This is small. A tiny one. Yeah, it was a 6. It wasn't a 4. So I had like some solid horsepower.
A 4.
4-cylinder, 6-cylinder, and then you have an 8, which you can get in a Bronco. Like,
well, but the OJ
Bronco
is the 8.
Yeah, the OJ was the 8. Yeah. Well, you can get the OJ car in a 6 too.
Oh really?
I had the same size engine, but in a Bronco too.
Oh shit!
So there was some stuff that truck could do that I was in, like, oh my god, I just did that. It was
so
awesome.
So wait, I'm not sure the geographics of a Bronco.
Uh-huh.
So two front seats,
Not this close.
Not a bucket,
right?
A
little bit tighter. No, bucket.
No, bucket? Okay. Yeah, no, bucket seat on the front. Uh-huh. See, this is what I mean. Mm-hmm. I don't know this. Okay, so bucket seat on the front.
Couch in the back that folds down.
Just one?
No, third row. Like, sofa seater in the back and it folds down.
And then the... And
no, just, third row. Okay. No third row. Yeah, all right. There's no third row. It's okay. Just a straight like trunk. It's more or less like a... It's like the first SUV. Like if you look at the FJ Cruisers, the old FJ Cruisers, they're a little bit smaller than the Broncos.
I just didn't know if there was like a bucket or it was just like...
I want to say you could get the back seats in bucket too, but like it wasn't the same. Like mine was like a traditional like Bronco too.
Okay.
Yeah. So the treat it like a Jeep. Like the thing handled like a Jeep. It had the suspension like a Jeep. Like it was rough.
You called it a Jeep?
Pretty much. Like, I mean, the thing was just, it was a rough ride, but it was so much fun. I miss that truck so much. I put it through 310,000 miles. It lasted. The guy that I turned
it
into.
Even my MR2 doesn't have that many miles.
It was.
How many years did you have it? Like what?
From 98 to
brand new?
2002. So
was it brand new when you got
No, hell no. No, it was okay, 89. So you got, I had it from 98. So it was like.
So you got it with how many miles? Roughly
120.
Oh shit, you got it. Oh.
Yeah, I got it about 120.
Oh shit, okay.
What was cool though is the guy that I bought it off of, he had the tires redone, the transmission had been redone, the engine needed a little bit of work, so we put some.
Because Rocket likes a new tranny.
Yeah, but you know what I'm saying? We'll call her Tim.
He always likes a new tranny.
So, and I actually ended up having to replace the tranny because I drive like an asshole.
Of course, he got a new tranny.
Two.
Yeah. He's all about the trannies.
All about them trannies. But I overdid it in that car.
Of course.
Needless to say. Got a bit of a heavy foot.
Heavy foot. I like it.
Yeah, but.
But great that's truck. A lot of miles. Great. Fuck.
Yeah, it worked up to 310, and then we had to just put a bullet in her. She was done.
I've had my MR2 for. And I'm pretty sure I'll die with that car. Not in the car, hopefully. But I'll die, and that car will be in the garage.
Depends on where you're coming back from, right?
She's a 2003. I bought her brand new.
Nice.
She's a 2003. It's 2018. Now, she's 15 years old.
The MR2 isn't the MR2 anymore. It's a Spider, right?
Well, it's an MR2 Spider.
Right, but they've moved away from like the MR2 brand, and now it's...
Well, they just call it MR2 Spider.
They just call it a Spider. Oh, okay.
MR2
okay.
Spider. But gotcha. They haven't made a new one, otherwise I would probably get rid of her.
Oh, really?
Yeah. If they ever make another one...
Down.
I'd be like, shit, sorry. Sorry, girl. But there's only two cars I would replace her with. A brand new MR2 Spider.
Or a Porsche.
Correct.
Yep.
And
I know you. I know you.
Beautiful. But that girl, she only has 175.
That's impressive. 175,000
miles.
Considering.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. But you also have another car that you use.
I have
like
another
your,
car.
Your
so now,
car.
So now I drive her on the weekends.
We be driving, Miss Daisy.
Yeah. And even now when I drive her, I don't go past.
You don't, yeah, you don't.
I don't go past 4,000 RPMs. Mm. Before I would redline that shit. I'm like, fucking hey,
sporty little car.
Yeah.
And the thing I like about the MR2 is it's super lightweight.
It's lightweight
it's
as
very
fuck,
lightweight,
yeah.
But it's got like good low suspension. Like it's a street
it corners,
hugger.
It corners like it's on rails.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's beautiful. So to this day, I'll take a corner like it's on because you know it's tires. Who gives a shit? I'll replace them.
Tires are expensive.
Sure. Yeah. I found a set of tires that is perfect for this car. The tires that came with the car would hold on to fucking this wall upside down.
Spider-Man.
But they were made out of butter.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They would last me 6 months.
The
tires, every 6 months, I had to replace the back tires.
Well, when you drive like a NASCAR or Formula driver, that's you're going to burn through them.
Here's the funny part, because there's no weight in the front. The engine's in the back, nothing in the front. I didn't replace my front tires for 6 years.
Come on. 6 years?
6 years, my front
tires. Back tires, how many did you go through?
It's every 6 months.
Every 6 months?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, but there's no fucking weight on the front. They were barely
so
touching.
So you were literally just like basically doing a wheelie like every time you took a corner.
They barely touched. Yeah.
Nice.
Toyota even said, how is this possible? I'm like, I don't know. They're like, I think we got to replace them because they're going to go bad.
Wow. They aged.
Yeah.
Your front tires aged.
Yeah.
So you just literally left your foot on the gas pedal all the way down everywhere you went.
Yeah, everywhere. Yeah. And you could just – the fastest turn I've ever taken on the MR2. 55 miles per hour. Regular turn, you know, regular street turn, 55 miles per
hour. Like an L turn?
Yeah.
You're retarded.
55 miles per hour.
You trusted those tires way too much. would be dead.
It was the same. It was the same corner I'd taken every day, every day. It was on. This is when I lived in Rancho Santa Margarita, and it was turning into the toll road.
Oh, off the 73.
Yes,
I know exactly which turn you're talking about. So, I know
not,
that
not
one.
The 73. No, Rancho Santa Margarita. Is this turning into the 241?
Oh,
I'm on
Santa Margarita Parkway.
Yeah.
I kind of know that turn. Yeah. Not the same as the 73.
Not the 73. Yeah.
I'm thinking about Laguna Canyon.
Yeah, I was coming in downhill and I would just turn that shit and I started at 35, 40, 45.
Where's your way up? You hit 55 and you're like, that's enough.
Whoa. My ass puckered up. I'm like,
yeah.
Okay. And the tires didn't even squeak. I'm like, that's interesting. Oh shit. I'm like, I could probably take it 60, but I'm gonna shit myself. So no.
I'm gonna have to take you over to my brother in law's house one of these days. He's got a 73 Challenger.
Ooh,
660. Challenger. 660 horsepower.
Okay.
To the tranny.
Before I forget, there's a fun show on Netflix called Fastest Car.
Oh, really?
Yes. Check it out. It's 8 episodes. I watched them all last night.
No surprise.
I fast forwarded a lot because I'm like,
they start slow.
Yeah, I'm like, I watched the first episode to its fullest and then I'm like, boring. They have one supercar, you know, Ferrari, Lamborghini, you name it. You know the supercars.
Oh, they're doing a pairing. So one supercar versus?
Versus three sleeper cars, meaning you could have a Honda Civic with turbos
something
and
under the belly that you have no idea about. Nice.
You have no idea.
I've seen a Pinto take out a Ferrari.
Exactly. Yeah. That kind of thing. So it's a show about, so they do 7 competitions and then on the final show it's 8 cars. The winners show up.
Oh, and they all have to race each other.
And they race.
Ooh, that's
they
cool.
Go to the desert in California and it's just light, go. Quarter nice. Mile.
So was it all, like, it couldn't have all been supercars.
No,
supercars
I'm not
going to
ruin it.
Yeah.
I'm not going to ruin it.
It's got to be all like the.
I'm not going to ruin who won.
What you call them, sleeper cars?
Sleeper cars. That's what they call them, sleeper cars.
I've seen
cars.
Some crazy sleeper
so,
cars.
So I'm not going to ruin it.
My friend of mine back in the day had
they give you a lot of backstory about, oh, I built this for my brother. Mike. Fuck you. I don't give a shit. Yeah.
Let's see you go. Go.
Let's go.
That's why I'm watching the show. Drive fast. Yeah. Now.
So it's called Fastest Car. Check it out. You can fast forward through the
sappy stories. It's on Netflix?
Yeah, it's on Netflix.
Yeah, totally check
fast forward through the sappy stories. Stop when you get to when they get to the race day. Watch race day and then next episode. Yeah.
That's kind of unfortunate. Yeah. It's all this production for us to just fast forward.
I mean,
you can watch
the entire episode. See what you think.
Quick segue before we come back to this.
Sure.
So Netflix is in the middle of a bit of a stock market adjustment. I don't know if you've been paying attention to this. So their numbers are moving up and down, and there's a reason for it.
So have you, Facebook?
Yeah. So we're not going to get into that one either. But that's like getting into politics right now, honestly. Like when you talk about like these massive infrastructures, like what's going on. But Netflix is doing something interesting where they're putting a lot of their money into production and actually building content, right?
I need to call pizza soon. Yes, go ahead.
My thoughts, and I brought this up to my wife last night. I'm very, very sure that this is going to happen.
Sure.
Netflix is going to move into live TV.
Oh, I'm sure they are.
How do you feel about that? Do you think that that's going to be like they'll be the new NBC, CBS, ABC, whatever it's going to be?
Well, we know for a fact Apple's moving in that territory.
I didn't
TV.
Know that.
Yeah, they're creating their own content.
Okay.
They have bought a studio or they're building their own studio. They have signed up Reese Witherspoon. They have signed up
Zac Efron.
Rachel from Friends. What's her name?
Aniston? Jennifer Aniston.
Did
that just happen? Did you really just ask me Rachel from Friends? What's her name?
Yeah, I've been drinking. Yeah. They have signed a lot of talent. And they're gonna have their own thing.
I'd consider Jennifer Aniston talent. Yes.
Yeah.
These are true words.
Yeah, but you know, they're gonna have their own thing. I think future
Apple's moving into actually doing like a Netflix type of like live
the future
sling.
The future is cable, sorry.
It really
You're
is.
Out.
It really so it's
future is apps.
I want to see who's like obviously Netflix
it's gonna
and
be a
Hulu
war.
Are on the like
here's
the front
fun
lines.
Part. Here's the fun part.
I love this shit. We don't do this. This is the last episode.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. We lost the...
No, it's because... Actually, let me call pizza. Before we keep going, what would you like? The everything or the meat lovers?
Meat lovers.
Meat lovers. All
More
right.
about that meat. Know what I'm saying?
How do I call them? There it is. Okay, we're
going to... So it's an iPhone. There's literally a giant green button with a phone
on
it.
We're going to go to music for now.
Muzak. While Beans is ordering pizza.
Hi, can I place an order for delivery?
Sure, what can I get for you?
Can I get the small meat lovers with a side of jalapeno?
That hurt! Five jalapenos, okay.
Ow! No, nothing else.
Okay, can you address, please?
You suck! Hold on. Explain, because nobody heard this shit. Please explain what the fuck you're doing, you fuckwad. I couldn't even say my phone number.
So Beats thought it'd be a good idea to order pizza in the middle of our episode.
I thought so, yeah.
And I basically told him that was a bad idea.
Holy shit!
I proceeded to act like I was caged and screaming and wailing in the middle of his phone call ordering pizza.
I could not say my phone number.
You didn't record any of that?
No.
Oh, shit. You guys missed out.
Well, we may have recorded the first part.
Oh, I literally cried.
Because when he said, what would you like? We were still alive. When he said, what is your address? That's when I muted.
And I proceeded with, get out of your cage! Don't touch me there!
He's like, what's your phone number? I'm like, 949. He's like,
I don't think he could handle the phone call either, though, because he was stumbling a little bit too. Oh, I'm so proud of myself. That was beautiful. Good last episode.
Wait till tomorrow, bitch. Episode. Wait till tomorrow, bitch. Okay, so what is Asher Matt said? Veggie pizza. Oh, veggie pizza. No. Fuck that noise. No, and what did
Asher Matt said? Here's your pizza and a domestic violence investigation. You did hear it. Yes.
I told you. I played
the first
half,
part of
I
it.
I played
yes.
the first half. Till they got to the address and the good stuff. Yeah.
I used to work Holy for shit. Domino's. And back in the day.
Domino's.
Yeah, we used to get some fun phone calls. We actually used to get some fun deliveries. I always got the fun stories. I never got one personally.
Never?
No, but those delivery stories.
So
are true.
They said about 25 minutes, and if we're on the show, and I'll run down, entertain the people.
I'm gonna continue to scream like I'm caged while they're answering the door. Somebody call the police!
I'm gonna get arrested.
You probably. I'll explain. I will.
All right, so. Next topic. Go ahead. Tell us about it.
I don't even know where we are. So let's talk about, Elmer.
Elmer.
My lovely, lovely son. We've had him on the episode several times in regards to conversation.
Yeah, Mike, we haven't had him on the show.
We've brought him up, rather, yes. several times on the show. My young lad. He's my oldest son. I have a younger one who's 4. Elmer is 6. He'll be 7 in August. And he's an awesome kid. He's just a very smart...
Before you continue, I've met both.
Uh-huh. You like Dill.
Well, no, wait.
Everybody likes Dill.
I would think the little one...
Was the bigger one.
Yes!
Yeah, because he's a fucking ogre. We'll get into that.
Okay, all right.
Because
like when you're telling the stories, I'm like, wait.
Wait, which one are we
backwards.
Talking about? Yeah. So my youngest son...
Yes!
...is massive. Like the kid like has a head like as big as my own. Like the kid is ginormous.
And I would think that would be Elmer.
Nope.
I know.
He's the young one.
I don't get that.
He's the one fucking with Elmer.
I don't get that. I thought it was backwards.
So Elmer is...
It doesn't make sense.
...having an awesome time at school. He's doing great. Well, academically, good. He's soaring. He's got a lot of friends.
Sure,
he's
sure.
doing good. But he doesn't know how to handle the bullies or the kids that want to push their way around. And
I'll say what I said earlier. Mm-hmm. I thought he would be the bully.
You would think, right? You would think.
Judging by the stories you have shared.
Yeah, we've got some stories that you think. But he's also a pacifist. He's one of those kids that, like, at home, if he starts getting on his brother, the first thing we say is, like, don't hit your brother. Don't smack your brother. Even though the little one is beating the shit out of him. But he's the little guy.
But the little guy. Yeah, but when you say the little guy, I think the little guy could probably take him.
No, the little guy does take him every fucking time. Yeah, and it's not because we let him. It's because we don't get to it till after the fact.
Let's stop using little. Yeah. The younger.
The younger guy. Because he definitely is not.
He's not little.
He's a big boy.
Yeah.
He's a beast of a kid. He's a fucking puck. So
he's gonna bunk you one of these days.
He's already has. Oh, yeah, no, he's right. An asshole. All so right, my little guy or my older little guy, Elmer.
My older little guy.
He's been having issues at school. There's one kid in particular that has found his way into Elmer's heart. And it's just bugging the shit out of him. He is picking on him at school. He's the bully. I won't get into the details because it's not worth it.
But I
would
think he could take him.
Well, he can, but he doesn't know that he can. And so...
Therefore, our topic.
I pick up Elmer the other day, and he's got like a black streak here and a black streak here. Shit. Like a bitch wearing mascara that was been crying all day. And come to find out, he was just dirty, and he was crying, but it was dirt. It was dirt.
First he got dirty, then he was crying, right?
Yeah, so he was dirty, he was crying, he was cheered up, and I was like, dude, what happened today? He's like, I had a bad day. And I was like, nah, you didn't tell me about it. Like, what's going on?
A yellow day?
It was actually a green day.
A green day!
It was a green day, which means that he had a good day. We rate it like a terrorist threat.
Yeah, we covered it. It's like going to the airport.
So he had a good day, but he had an incident on the playground where he brought toys with him to school, which he's not supposed to do. We don't allow him to take toys to school.
It's
I told him he's allowed to take
guns.
Like one Hot Wheels car and you can play with it after school. You're good. That's fine. But apparently he brought toys to school.
All right.
So I guess this kid pulled went into his backpack, pulled a toy out of his backpack, proceeded to break the toy and then throw it.
Motherfucker.
Kid's a douche, right? You know, typical bully scenario. And my son, rather than handle it the way that you should handle it, handled it the way that we would expect him to, which is to be responsible, go tell a teacher, cry about it, and just let them deal with it, right?
But that doesn't buy you a lot of street cred.
No, and it also doesn't show you how the real world works.
Right.
So I proceeded to tell my son when I picked him up from school that when something like this happens, and I won't say any names on the air or anything, I was like, but said person, you will take care of them. And I explained how. And I was like, when it comes down to it, you let them know that that's your shit.
And you glue them to the fucking wall.
Pretty much. pretty much. I said,
remember how you like the glue? Yeah. You fucking glue them
like,
to that shit.
You will handle this.
You duct taped them to a fucking toilet.
So we've kind of given this impromptu pass, go ahead and handle your stuff. You got mom and dad on your side. Like, it's cool. So I would assume within the next couple weeks, I will get a phone call. And I will explain when I get the phone call.
That this your is, kid got well, yeah. expelled because...
yeah, pretty much. So I'm interested to see...
He beat the shit out of Bruno.
No, I like that name. Bruno's a good name. I like that name.
Yeah.
I would hope that the phone call is your son got into an altercation and we had to pull him off.
And this
that
is
would be the best news.
And this is when I'll pitch in for the Hannah... tear tattoo.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Just a little one. Just for the week.
Just for the week.
And every time he looks over at good old Bruno, he's going to be like, what's up, bitch?
What up?
Yeah.
Like,
so
damn.
One of the things that I've decided to work on over the next week or two is to give him a couple lessons and talk to him about how he should compose himself and just let him know that it's okay.
How to take down a bully.
More or less.
I'm sure he can take down a bully.
I'm not saying that I condone the behavior, but I also don't agree with bullying.
No, but he needs to.
Yeah. When you got a kid that's like digging through your shit, throwing your stuff out, and purposely making you cry just because he can.
Yeah.
Come on, man. Don't be an asshole. Yeah. Like, we get that you're the
but
bigger
we,
kid.
There's always that asshole.
Yeah. And I got to deal with those assholes growing up.
Yeah.
And my dad handled it the same way. I came home one day, bloody.
Ooh.
And my dad looked at me and he's like, what happened? Oh, I got to fight with this guy. He's like, does he look worse than you? I was like, oh. He's like, I tell you what. If he doesn't go home looking worse than you, I'm going to fuck you up.
Oh, shit.
And I was like, oh, I don't want that. It's like, immediately it was like, that's a bad idea. So, and it never happened again.
Yeah, exactly.
So, cheers. Here's to Elmer versus the bully.
Go, Elmer. Because, you know, I'm not that of the bigger type. Right?
Nope.
And I have always, I don't know how. I really don't know how. 99% of my friends are jocks. They're always...
You're a sports guy, though.
I can talk sports.
You could talk the talk.
I
can't talk
the talk. If I was to look back, high school, like elementary, high school, college, all that good stuff, I make friends with the jocks by making them laugh. And then they're like, oh, you're in.
We like this guy.
And,
he's funny.
And now I'm protected by this pack of...
Big dudes.
Big dudes that... No, he's with us.
Yeah.
So whenever...
And you're standing in the middle like...
Yeah. I'm like, come at me. Yeah, come at me.
Hey,
guys, get closer.
Yeah. Hold me back. Yeah. No, really, hold me back.
Come at me, yeah. So I've always been in that... It's a weird situation, but I've always been in this pack of, like, jocks, and I'm always like, so come at me. You got to deal with them, but come at me. And that has always saved my life. I don't know how.
Now, when they're not around, because I've heard stories, sure, at least one that I can think of specifically.
Yeah. In a bathroom.
Where you get into an altercation. Do you think it's like that? The fact that you've had that backing before that gives you that gusto?
I think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm like, all right.
See, I was on the other end of the spectrum.
Because, like, okay,
I won't say that I was small.
He may kick my ass, but you're going to die tomorrow, mofo.
Mine was the crazy.
Oh, the crazy?
So, yeah. So, yeah. I'm a legitimately nice dude. Like, sure, through and through. Right. Most people that knew me, like, when I was bouncing the other night at the bar,
they're like,
were
really
making fun of me. Like, really, you're the bouncer? Like,
you're going to kick
some
ass? But
there were a couple comments about, like, well, we've seen you when you actually have had an altercation, and we were impressed.
Oh.
And... The whole basis of standing your ground and just, sure, holding your own, it holds precedence over whether or not it's going to go down or not.
And it does, because, yeah, I've said this before. Last time I get into an altercation, mm-hmm, and by the way, I was alone.
Yeah.
And there was a guy that was 6 foot tall, and I was just like, bitch, bring it. Yeah, I'm like, I'll go spider monkey on your ass. And he was like, He doubted himself, and I didn't.
Yeah.
I didn't back down.
There's something to be said
about like, not a backing level down. Of confidence, yes,
and whatever. My wife always gives me a hard time. She's like, you're always
not
so
only
confident.
Not only that, but the girls
that helped.
That heard what happened, drip, drip, drip.
Yeah, buddy.
Drip, 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 drip.
Oh, street cred. Oh, the street cred.
They're like.
Did they have some, like, commission for you?
Yes.
Nicely,
yeah,
done. All right,
like,
you get double that tonight. Nicely,
yeah,
done.
No, all yeah. Right. And by the way, it's a small... Aliso's a...
not a big community.
It's
at least the crowd that you run with.
It's a bigger town, but everybody knows everybody. And, like, within the next...
Bigger than Anchorage.
Yeah. But when the next 2 weeks, they're like, hey, we heard. I'm like... How the fuck did you hear? Like, you weren't there.
You heard about Betsy Ross? Yeah, they're like, whoever.
And, like, there's a guy named Mario who still tells the story of, oh, that bit, because he was at the bar.
Nice.
He's like, I saw that guy. You do not mess with that motherfucker.
That's so cool.
He will go spider monkey on your ass.
That's like, the best. You're like, I have history. I have history.
Yeah, like, that is so cool.
When your name precedes you, and you're like, oh, that's a crazy motherfucker. Oh, no, we're good.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
oh, we got Darren that just chimed. He said, I've always told my kids they will never get in trouble with me if they get in a fight as long as it Seymour click the button.
Hold on, as long as.
Sorry, Darren, you wrote too big of a comment and Facebook doesn't allow us. Is in self defense.
Oh, yeah, no, if it's self defense. Yeah. Fuck him up.
Yeah, no. So, and that was exactly what my dad was trying to say. He knew. I don't start fights. I've never started a fight in my life. There was one of those, like, you got messed up. He's like, did he look worse than you? I legitimately had no idea. Honestly, I don't think he did, because I don't even know if I hit him. Like, it was a bad scenario.
Sure, sure.
But it was the reaction that he had where he was like, you're going to take care of this or I'm going to take care of this. And I was just like,
all right,
let's not
do that.
And so I took care of it.
Yeah,
and I won't get into that, but I took care of it. So my boy, he's young. He's got a bit of an issue with, you know, somebody being a bit of an ego and just feeling like the bigger kid. And sometimes it's time to just like cut him down to size.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not condoning violence. Bad behavior, sure, or violence. I would never.
Well, you have to stand ever. Your ground.
But at the same time, there's no reason to be picked on.
Right.
There's no reason at all to be picked on. And so I lead with that and move on into our next segment, which is.
We need, first of all.
A show title!
Well, we need a show title. That's true. We do need a show title, but we do need a slow-mo. We need time for a slow-mo.
I would say 8 minutes and 8 seconds.
Why?
Because it's episode 80, and that's 8000 and 8000.
Alrighty. Now, with 8 minutes and 8 seconds. All right. With that, it's time to go to what?
Slow-mo theater.
Slow-mo theater. Here we go.
So fucking good. That being said, once he was done, he got off stage and was doing like a whole like come outside and take pictures with me and hang out and whatever. And that,
some
that
more pictures.
Yeah. Yeah, the guy was like super grateful for all the.
He's a picture whore.
Yeah, he. Well, he just.
Puddles.
Puddles. He's gotten a lot of credibility, but I gotta say it was an amazing show. Literally watching a guy dressed as a clown for 2 hours. Singing karaoke.
The story is more fun because it sounds like I'm drunk.
It really does, but if you saw it, you would have been like, I get it.
I get it.
No, it's cool, guys. I get it.
That's fun. Now.
And that was Slow Mo Theater.
With that, we have done, as of tonight, 80 episodes. We started back.
It's official.
We started back in 2016.
We did.
I was still a virgin at the time.
That's a fucking lie.
You were still in Alaska. It was a long time ago. That's also a lie. I lie a lot. That's a lie. That's also a lie. She was a puppy.
Nope.
Nope.
Again, a lie.
But I wanted to ask you, and do you have favorite moments on the show? And I'll give you time to think about this. Mm-hmm. Because I actually have favorite moments on the show.
I'm hoping that it comes up.
Yes.
Because I know that you've kind of put something together for us.
I did.
But there's one in particular that I want to bring up, hopefully that you did work all into right. this. And it's when
Save
I
it.
Completely
Save it.
Went off on you over a specific type of garment that you wore.
Oh, okay. Let's save it.
Okay.
Okay. Leave it at and that. With that, it is time for Beans' favorite moments. Oh, shit. Okay, so we pimped this at the beginning of the show.
We did.
We are going to have a Mac versus PC challenge.
Let me join the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Let's get ready to rumble!
Okay. So, to be fair, Beans thinks he's funny and put like the most ancient PC he could ever put on a graphic.
Yes, I did.
Oh my god. That was like a DOS based, like, I think that's what they had in that movie, War Games with Matthew Broderick. Like, hello. Oh my god. That was your
yes.
dick.
Yeah, I'm a dick.
So,
yeah.
Kudos. You are technically controlling all the graphics.
We
on the
knew
show,
that.
So.
We knew that. So, hold okay. on. Ready? And Pete, I'm gonna move my legs out of the way a little bit. We'll do a countdown in 3, 2, 1, go.
Go. Alright, so both machines are on the boot process. You get
I got
to start
the boom.
Do you get the boom still?
Yes.
No,
I see nothing. The Apple logo. I see nothing on yours. Did you hit start? Oh, jeez.
Yeah, no.
Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah. Your keyboard is on.
Oh.
And.
Ooh, look at this.
I see a Lenovo.
Oh.
Boom!
Ouch. Okay, so. I gotta log in, so.
Oh! I saw the dock way before I even saw your login screen. Wow.
Man. All right.
All right.
So, Mr. Beans.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead.
I'm going to go first.
Oh, fuck yeah, you're going first.
Hold on. Come on, be a good one. And by the way, let's not drop one because.
And I'll go ahead and
listener
read
the, Kate is going to.
Oh, God. Yeah. I'm going to read the possible flavors.
Right.
Oh, green.
I got green for anybody watching. Here, I'm showing it to the camera.
Okay, so this is the bright green one. So it could be either lime or. Lawn clippings.
That's not terrible.
That's
I'll
not
take
terrible.
That. I'll take
I have
that.
A feeling this one's going to get
I'll
choked down
that.
Regardless. So
that.
Let's see what it is. Does it taste like your yard? Get some of that.
Odd part is I don't taste anything. No. Lawn clippings.
There it is. There it is. That's the face I was waiting for.
Not terrible, by the way.
Not terrible, but bad. All right.
Very chokeable. All right.
Take the
hat. Very choke. Can I have water?
Yeah, you can drink some water and wash it down.
Oh, hold on.
So, I mean, there's
not
everything
terrible.
From stinky socks to barf right. to canned
so,
dog food. Oh,
here we go.
Jesus Christ.
Get it all up in there. All
right. And what's I got like? A brown one. And the brown one, oh, fuck. Could be chocolate pudding or canned dog food.
That's not bad. Rocket? Let's see.
Mm.
Oh, it is the canned dog food.
It's canned dog food. It tastes like old
Does
beef.
Does it taste like...
Oh, God.
Here's the funny part. I can smell it.
Oh.
I can smell the Choke it down.
It's gone.
Directly to our confetti fund.
Are we doing that?
Oh, we're going to do it
let
right
do
up.
Right away.
Let's just do it. So we actually have a GoPro shooting at high res. We're doing 120 frames per second. So when we slow it down to 24 to 30 frames per second, it's just
so
going to look
exciting.
Pretty fucking badass.
I'll give you a preview of what it's going to look like. Because that's
So I'm going to hit record. There.
We are now recording.
GoPro is now recording at 120 frames per second.
This is the most fun I've had all week. I love these things. I love the fact that it's your birthday and you're letting me be the one to shoot.
You have to. You go giddy for this.
I get giddy.
Yes.
Giddy.
You may want
to I'm getting there. I got to work my body over.
You want to go low so we can make the most effect.
All right.
I'm still wearing a few pieces. Raise the glass. Because tonight is not just any regular episode, not any old weird episode that we have here at the Angry Beagle Studios. No, that, yeah, I was
going
to
I was like, where are you going?
at the Angry Beagle Studios. We have accomplished a milestone.
Have we now?
We are on double digits. This is episode this many. This is episode...
Episode 10.
10. We are no longer in single digits. We are now in double digits.
It's official.
Little hole.
I am so excited. I'm terrified. Yeah. This better be the screenshot for our episode.
All right.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, and... Woo!
Told you. Woo! I'm still wearing half of it.
I am getting one of these for New Year's. I love it.
It's the big comeback.
The big
Frosty,
comeback.
The Snow Bean.
Yeah.
Sure. So this song was written for Beans about, my daughter was 6 at the time, so 10 years ago at least, which is like way prior to me meeting Beans. But the short of it is if you have ever met that one random guy in the bar that was trying to pick up on you and failed miserably, this song is basically him in first person.
Oh, the logo.
Ooh, check this out. Oh, the logo's all over the place. Yeah. Ah, keep it there. Keep it there.
Yeah.
Oh, it looks like Ustream crashed from what listener Andy's saying. You guys have to forgive me. This song was written 10 years ago, so I've got to figure it out. So, again, this is Beans in action. I wrote you this love note on this here napkin. I know what you're thinking, this ain't how love supposed to happen. Just do me a favor and read my dear. I'll be right back, just gotta go get another beer. And so she proceeds to read, and this is what it says. Bright night, baby, at the end of the bar. Yeah, you really don't know just how lucky you are. I'm the man of your dreams, just went to buy you a drink. And when I get back, I expect a little kiss on the cheek. So, what's it gonna be? 'Cause here I come. As I walk back to her, she's not looking at me. Now she's staring at some other dude, so there'll be no kissing on the cheek. I swallow my pride, take that note and put it back in my pocket. I pop my collar and start walking on to the next one. Blue-eyed angel at the other end of the bar. Yeah, you really don't know just how lucky you are. I'm the man of your dreams, paid no attention to the bitch behind me. Yeah, she don't know a good thing when she sees. Oh, when she sees it. And that's Beans at the bar.
All right, Rocket, what did you think?
I love it. The fact that you, A, put me up there two times shooting confetti cannons.
That's because fantastic. Confetti cannons are fun. I would have had confetti cannons tonight, but I didn't want her shitting her pants.
She might die.
Yeah.
She might die.
She's already nervous.
Yeah,
as it is.
She's...
Otherwise, I don't...
Why is she so nervous tonight? Like, you can almost, like, tell that, like, she knows it's the last episode. Okay, so there were two major moments in the show that I remember that were...
Aside from confetti cannons.
Yeah, confetti cannons were, like, a given. Like, yeah, come on.
Did you like the slow-mo?
Yes, that.
Yeah. On one of the videos, you said I'm gonna get one for New Year's, but no, you didn't. You got four.
I got four, and I set off
the long
all four.
Cannons, right?
Yeah, they were the tall boys, and my wife was so mad at me. No joke, I actually was cleaning the living room a week ago.
All right,
and a small piece of confetti came out. I have no idea from where.
What's up there?
But it was one of those. There is still a little gold star in the studio. Till this day, it's been almost 2 years.
And a dent.
And a dent. Actually, a couple dents. There's a couple.
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
So there was one moment in particular that I remember so, so very, very all well. Right. And it was the day that you came out and told me that you had
I didn't come out.
No, you didn't come out. But you did admit.
Admit. Is
to owning a silk red robe.
Yes, I
now,
do.
Now, among all the things that you own, because I know that you own a pair of Uggs and jeggings and a numerous pair of sandals that you take with you on trips because you just don't know what the event might call for. So no, why well, not?
It's not you got to match the bathing suit.
So let's not get into that again. That's like yeah, we're right. not doing that again.
That's not gonna help.
But
and the, I have a massive amount of gray shoes.
Yeah, this is true. But touche. So do I. Yeah, well, these are black gray, today, oh, but yes, okay. Those are dope. By the gray. Way. These are some nice Adidas. You got some new Adidas.
I just picked like up these new kicks.
Oh, they be nice.
Today.
Those. So.
And by the way, when you walk on them, because I'm a Converse guy.
You get the squishy?
No. But when I walk on them, I'm like, it's like walking on fucking pillows.
Ooh.
They're comfortable as
the
fuck.
Adidas? All right.
Yeah. The back of it is a little tall.
Mm-hmm.
I wish it was a little shorter.
Everything for you is a little tall.
But walking on them, I'm like, compared to the Converse, I'm like, it's like walking on fucking pillows. Mm. Check them out. You got to check them out.
He does.
Yeah, right. Check them out.
So you opened up that you own a red silk robe. Red robe.
Yes, I do.
Not just a robe. I own a robe. I own a robe. I have a nice long black.
Nah, it's red.
I think it's made out of felt. Like it's just a big ugly ass robe.
Mine is silk and it's red. Yeah. I've showed it here on the show.
I don't gallivant around my house with it. It's just a big ugly robe.
Sure,
you own a silk red robe. You own jeggings. You own Uggs. And I lost shit so much when you opened up about the robe. I don't think I've ever just shit on you in the middle of a show as much as I did the day that you brought up the red robe.
Sure, sure.
The red robe episode was quite honestly probably one of my favorites.
Ashen Matt are saying?
Ashen Matt says yes. We gave Bean so much crap for that. Dude.
You did.
You own a red robe.
And if I had the lady balls, I would go change right now into the silk robe, the jeggings, and the Uggs.
I say you do it before the pizza guy gets here.
I don't know when the pizza guy is going to get here.
It's got to be in the next 10 minutes. It's somewhere around there. I say
I have the lady balls to go and put on the tight pants, the Uggs, and the silk robe.
All I'm going to say is I don't want to see any of that.
Ah, there you go. See, you're afraid.
Yeah.
You're afraid that I'm going to seduce you with my sexiness.
Nope. That's not
yes.
it.
And I'll spray. I'm gonna spray some Black Panther on. Yeah.
Pretty sure that's not it.
Yep.
I'm
you're afraid of your own sexuality. It's okay.
You've got me. What can I say?
You're like, yeah.
Yes.
Yep.
You got me. I have no way of backing out of this. Good on you. Ash Matt say yes. Beans gave me so much crap for that. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So moving
is
right on.
Is there any other spots that you can think of, so that you're like, shit.
The first
did you
time,
like, did you like the? Because I, of course, I was gonna call you out on the computer.
Okay, so the best part about that whole scene was, yes, not only did you stomp me, and you absolutely stomped me, but my computer boots up, and the wallpaper that I had at the time was "Get More Done."
How'd that come along?
The irony was painful. I just realized that now.
He's done less.
70 episodes later.
Mine, if I was ever write a book, it would be called Do Less.
Do Less.
But for me to write the book, it would be doing more. So that's for the... No, do less. In life, do less. Yeah. The less you can do, you win.
And that's your final thought. We're closing out the show. Have a good night.
No, do less.
I would say that there's a couple like key moments that we had in the show. I loved it when we had...
Oh, I should admit.
Hey, 60% of the time it works all the time.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah.
No, they're talking about Black Panther. They know what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yes, I saw Black Panther. I know where
you're Black Panther? No. It's from Anchorman. So Paul Rudd sprays himself with Black Panther. It's illegal in 3 countries. 60% of the time, it works all the time.
I didn't know
that. To get the ladies.
Yeah. I was just following along.
No. Black Panther is the name of a cologne on Anchorman.
I vaguely remember that.
All right.
Okay. I get it.
Not Black Panther, the superhero.
Dude, Will Ferrell. He almost died.
Yeah, I know. Right here. Oh, my God. Right next door to my house.
Right over here. Yeah. Like, literally right over here.
It was either Will Ferrell or the drummer for Guns N' Roses. I don't know.
No, it was confirmed it was Will Ferrell.
No, I know, but they look the same.
No.
You've seen them both, right?
Yes. Yes, I have. Okay.
Yeah.
What the hell was I saying? I don't remember where I was at.
The computer competition.
So the computer boots up and it says, get more done. And there was this like sadistic laugh that Beans has. He's all and just
like pure defeat. Like I was done.
Like it get was, less done.
It was unfortunate. Uh-huh. Yeah. And this, we haven't had a competition like that since.
Because it was a 2006 MacBook Pro against a
versus 2017. It was a newer, yeah. It was like at least a year within a year of being new.
And you're like, I upgraded to. I'm like, bitch.
Didn't matter. Didn't matter.
I'm like, let's do this.
I wonder how much of it's software versus hardware.
Software, I think.
Yeah.
Well, at this point, my hardware was obsolete.
Yeah. But the software
but
still
the
ran
software
well.
Software was still solid.
You still beat me.
Yeah, but the software no was still problem. Solid. Yeah.
I wonder if we should have gotten into processes. Like, let's. No, because we did. We opened up like a Word
document. Yeah, we opened Word.
I have no way of beating you on this one.
Not only I could have done video if you wanted to. Yeah.
Yeah. No. Don't replay. We're good. I'll take a hard pass. So the confetti cannons were always the bomb. Dying. No dying beans.
Whoa. Wrong pipe.
That's what she said.
Yeah. Exactly. Who? Taking a sip and taking and breathing at the same time?
Yes, it was an SSD for Windows. Ashley Matt's asking, thanks for the reminder.
No, so what I was going to say. Wow. What were we talking about?
I don't know. You were coughing up a storm of remembering
but just
something.
Before that.
Remembering.
Oh, my biggest accomplishment for you is when I met you, you were Windows Phone. Then you went to Android phone, and my biggest accomplishment is now, what do you have now?
iPhone 8 Plus.
Yeah, buddy. That is my biggest accomplishment yet. Soon enough, you'll be like, I bought me a MacBook Pro.
No, I don't think. Okay, so.
It would change your life.
I got the opportunity to take a contract position
with a
client. And the catch was that I had to work in a Mac-based environment.
It would change your life.
I was pretty sure I couldn't pull it off. I was like, I don't know what I'm doing.
I would show you three things, and it would change your life. You'd be like, why am I not doing this all the time?
The left nut, the right nut, and the shaft.
Do you have any other favorite moments on the show?
There was the robe moment, and then there was the episode that you were talking about packing.
I'm a diva.
Yes,
you're
a diva.
I almost picked that one up, yes.
Oh, my God. Okay, so there was this instance where...
It's on YouTube, by
the way. I asked you how much you were packing.
Yeah, to go to Cancun.
And you were so open
Europe
about it. You were so like just, what? What?
I forget what
and
I
was... And to this day, I will still judge you indefinitely for...
I don't know if it was when I was going to Europe or Cancun.
No, it was Cancun, for okay. sure. Yeah, no, I can guarantee it was for Cancun.
Yeah, I was packing, like, you know, five different bathing suits with... Three different flip-flops that would match the bathing suit because you don't know. You don't want to clash. Yeah.
Case in point.
Yeah.
No.
It was a mix. I had to check in my suitcase.
Yeah, I know. How did that go with the other three? Dude, you packed so much.
I do pack a lot.
How long were you gone?
Like 4 days. You got to be prepared.
Dude, the goal. You don't know. We got to find the episode number for that one, and that should be the show title. It is on YouTube. That specific
one. So if you go on YouTube, it's called Beans is a Diva.
Yes.
So go to our YouTube channel.
True stories have never been told.
I almost picked that up because I thought it was awesome.
I lost my shit when you talked about how many shoes. Not even shoes.
Oh, shoes, yeah.
Sandals you packed for yourself.
Shoes, I packed like 6 or 7, maybe 8.
It still
on vacation.
Me. I'm so mad at you.
Right you never now. Know. You never know what you're gonna need.
No, I do know. That's why I own
like,
a
brown
pair. No,
you
just
gray. You need.
They're called rainbows.
Flip flop.
They're called rainbows. No chick is gonna walk up to you and be like, "Yo, bro, those sandals, huh?" And you're like, "Yeah, they're rainbows. Like they're black."
I've been at Shmopa where a lot of girls are going. Those are really nice shoes.
Orange County, dude.
Orange County, dude.
Ash and Matt.
Yes.
I'm pretty sure this was Ash. She said, he likes options.
That's right. I do like options.
Fuck your options. Be a man.
I am a man. Who likes options?
Nope.
Nope.
Not going to do it.
I like options.
Not going to do it.
I like options.
I literally have two pairs of shoes. In general.
That's one. And two.
The other look like those. Ish. What are they? Vans. They're the Vans.
Oh, okay. How about dressy shoes? You got to have dressy shoes.
Yeah, I've got a pair of dressy shoes. I have a pair of dressy shoes. How many pairs of dressy shoes do you have, Beans?
Four. Wait.
Five. And how high are the heels?
They're stilettos. Yeah.
6 inch.
6 inch. They make me about 5'2".
Okay, that's the third dap for the evening. Nicely done. Yeah, so I would say out of the moments that I've had, the most fun that I've had is being able to blatantly contrast how different we are.
The
show has been a lot of fun for the fact that you and I are polar opposites, but true. We have a lot of fun on the show. And
it's true.
It's been a good time.
Yes. Were you nervous the first day?
Absolutely. You watch the first episode.
0.5.
Not number one. Even watch one, but 0.5 was hilarity.
You're like, oh.
I was not prepared.
And it's still available.
My face was red.
Sure.
The entire episode. There was never a point where it dulled in redness. True.
I like it.
Yep. Now, I would say out of everything we've done, the confetti cannons, definitely a must.
Those are awesome.
Slow-mo theater, I don't know why I enjoy it so much, but
because
I do.
Because we sound drunk?
Yeah. The comments, we've
although
got
you
a
made
few.
Fun of my video, but then you liked it.
Of course. Of course. It's not fun unless I pick on you.
And then?
Final thoughts. Like, we have the most random final thoughts.
Shit.
There's times where you can tell they're prepared. And there's other times where you're just like,
I listened to last week's show. I'm like, yeah, you had one.
I had a good one.
I was digging. I had
hard.
Nothing. But today I have one.
You had like a Dremel motor. And we're
well, I played the Jeopardy theme. Yeah, I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah, you didn't have it.
No, I didn't have anything.
So, but yeah.
Today I do have one. So with that, it is time to see what Brother Barney, the Barnacle, has to say in this weekend, bro.
Let us read from the book, of Bro.
Tell us about it. Wow, Kate just jumped on my lap.
Hi, Kate.
How are you doing?
Welcome to number article 80.
80! Our last article. There's more, but...
This is like the extended version.
Oh, okay. Tell us about it, Rocket.
A bro shall make every effort to aid another bro in riding the tricycle, short of
what did I just say?
Completing the tricycle himself. Now, there's a bunch of other shit in here. Just bear with me. Yes, a bro shall make every effort to aid another bro in riding the tricycle. Short of completing the tricycle himself.
True that. You don't want a cock block.
No.
You don't want a cock block.
I got this. You didn't. I'm on my way.
That's right.
So that being said, rules for riding the tricycle. The aggregate
and
age of all three participants shall not exceed 83 years.
Check.
Where did that rule come from? 83.
So
excuse me, Mother Teresa.
Whenever Barney came up with a random stat, it was always 83. 83% of blah, blah, blah. 83%.
You know, entirely
which, by the
too
way,
much.
Here's the funny part. Barney's number was always 83% of blah, blah, blah. 83, 83, 83. My number is 17. With Barney.
That's going to be a thing.
Beans
we're
going
to have to go back. We're going to have to rewind some episodes and find out.
100%.
Listener, Sally. Is
hello!
On the air.
Hey!
So, rules of riding the tricycle.
Yes.
Option number two. The aggregate weight of all three participants shall be less than 400 pounds or 181.44 kilograms if you're in another country.
check.
Number three. No money or other considerations are to be exchanged for services rendered.
True that.
You can't hire a slut.
No, you can't hire a hooker.
Number four, pregnant women shall consult with their physician. I don't want to read this anymore. Number five, no wheel of the tricycle shall be within three branches of another family's tree.
That's true.
Ew, that's true. Of course not.
No cussing.
Gross.
No cussing.
That's gross.
No crossing. No, no.
That's gross.
Yeah.
Six, no black soled sneakers. Why?
I don't know.
Number eight, kitchen appliances and other electrical devices are strictly forbidden.
Wow. Okay.
Only because of the, what is it called? The mixer.
Yeah, yeah.
Number 9, participants must shower before riding the tricycle and
makes sense.
Definitely after.
Makes sense.
And that being said, that's number 80 of the Book of Bruh.
I like it. I like it. Where's my pizza?
81 super short. Would you like me to read it? We're not going to have another article. Are we doing it? What do we do?
I see
some disdain here.
I say you save it. All right,
I'll save it.
You never know.
I feel like Beans has a notion for the future.
7 years from now.
7 years from now.
It'll be
like 2 months and he's going to be like,
Rocket may
come
be
to
like,
a show.
Rocket may be like, I want to do a show. I'm like, oh, this dude.
I like how both of us used each other as the excuse. I was like, Beans is going to be like, I need a show. And apparently Rocket needs
Sally, he's coming over in about 3 months. I have the space. I don't know what to do with it, so it's just going to stay like this.
I would suggest porn. You've got some
porn.
Porn.
Well, I just
you have the, exceptional lighting.
I need the woman.
Honest. I'm
willing.
Out. I'm out.
I need,
I'm out.
I need
I'm
a
out.
Willing woman.
Kate is single. And she looks lonely. I'm pretty sure that it's illegal in most countries.
She looks
but
sad.
If you keep.
So, yeah, yeah, yeah.
If you keep it on the, what is it, the black internet? The dark web?
Dark web.
The dark web.
You don't even know? You
no,
should know this.
I know nothing about the internet.
You should know this. Anywho, you have to take a shot. Have you ever cock blocked a bro from a tricycle? I was talking to you earlier today, and I called it a tricycle, and you're like, so what?
Yeah.
See?
Okay. So to be fair, only to aid in my reasons for explaining the episode to my wife later when I get home.
Well, you can give her more detail.
Well, no. So I learned what a tricycle was today.
Right.
Which was profound. I was like, oh, nicely done. Basically, it's a threesome.
Basically, it's a threesome. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That's
yeah.
That's the whole of it.
Sure,
but
sure.
A bro should never get involved in.
Have you ever? Have you ever cock blocked a bro?
I don't remember the last time I had a bro that had the opportunity of doing a tricycle, let alone like get in the way of it.
I call it the tricycle. I call it the belt as well.
I'm not going to get into that one.
No. All right. So with that, I don't know where my pizza is, but sure hope it's coming.
No pizza yet.
They said 25 minutes. I'm still waiting. So anywho,
I'm gonna scream in the background.
Please
when they
do
come
not
to drop off. It's gonna be amazing.
I'm gonna close the door.
The police might come, and I will explain thoroughly.
This is why I'm not getting my pizza. All right. Yeah. SWAT is downstairs. Going. Okay. Ready? We're gonna break in. 1, 2. They're gonna fucking break my door.
I will replace your door one of these days. I hope the SWAT breaks in. Okay. So moving right along.
Moving right along. This week. This week I had a revelation.
I have so much to contribute.
Therefore
please.
Okay. That's why I had to bring it up. And I did not. It's still here. It's still hanging. Mm-hmm. And I'll turn so you can see. So this week something shocking happened to me. I was brushing my teeth, I believe. I wasn't doing my hair. I was brushing my teeth, and I look over. I'm like, so what? So, and I stopped. I'm like, whoa. I have gray hair on my beard. Hmm. If I let my beard grow, it kind of comes out salt and pepper.
It does its thing.
Salt and pepper.
Yeah.
Never in any way, shape, or form has the gray crossed on to the southern border, to the northern border.
Alcohol is bad.
Yeah, 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 yeah. No, I built a fucking wall. Like, that shit ain't crossing.
Yep.
But there was one motherfucker.
This is like North Korea shit.
Yeah, there's this
there was that one.
There's this one motherfucker that crossed the border. I'll turn so you can see if it's still there. I have not plucked it. It's somewhere in here.
Yep.
I have one motherfucking gray hair. Tomorrow I will pluck it. I didn't because I wanted you to see it. But tomorrow, that bitch is gone. I'm going to pluck the shit out of all these hairs. Of course, then I posted that on Facebook. And I believe your wife said, well, it could be worse. And I posted a picture of what Beans would look like if he was bald.
Which I replied with, what the hell did I say? It was something, along the lines of like, we'd make horrible babies or something like that. It was awful.
Yes.
No, you cannot be bald ever.
Oh, I think, listen to Twinkies watching.
What up? I think that you with a gray hair, a single gray hair.
I have one back here. One,
at the swell old age of like, what are you, like 56 now?
I'm 44, to be honest. You can go fuck yourself.
I'm just saying.
Go pound sand. 44, yeah.
I think you're like 20 years my senior.
20.
I was close.
Sure. Where's my pizza? I need pizza.
Where is your pizza? Where's my pizza?
Where is my pizza?
So, okay, you get a gray hair.
Yes.
You have the reaction that you do.
Yes.
Now, you can pluck it.
I can pluck it. I haven't. Okay. I will, no, but
joke.
I haven't.
I've been hanging out with you all night. I have not seen one fucking gray hair until you were like, look, right, and I had to get in there to see the gray hair. So, let me ask you this.
But I don't, here's the funny part. Beard, like, it grows till about here, and I haven't seen any gray come up. But all of a sudden, it jumped the border.
So you,
it's like a Mexican jumping TJ and landing in Washington. Like, I don't get it. I don't understand.
Ba-ba!
Yeah. I'm
like, and now chimichangas everywhere.
Yeah, like, I understand if it landed in San Diego. Sure.
That makes sense.
But no, that bitch went to Washington. Like, I don't get it.
It's like my wife
says. He's in Seattle right now, not in San Diego.
My vagina. My maiden name is Mexican. But I'm from Alaska, and then I moved to California, so I hopped two borders.
South.
Yes.
Not north.
So
like most Mexicans.
You went
the other way.
You have a single gray hair.
And now I'm concerned.
Okay. Not,
I'm concerned it's contagious.
Not with. So not including the goatee and the beard or whatnot.
Sure.
You have a single gray hair.
If you were to let your hair grow, how much gray are we talking?
I'm blonde. It doesn't matter. Yeah, I'm like that weird, like Swiss or Swedish, like it's just it'll grow froey. So I haven't trained my hair in years, but if it was to grow
it's
out,
curly,
it doesn't grow here. No, it's straight as fuck.
Oh, you said froey.
No, it's froey, but it just grows out. I'm like, okay, think of a chia pet that doesn't calm down. No joke, I swear to God, if I was to grow my hair out,
yes,
it's like it just goes wherever the atmosphere is. It just grows out. It doesn't calm down.
It just sticks out.
Yeah, it just goes out. So both my sons. One son has flat hair. When it grows, it just lays down nicely, and you can comb it,
that's
do whatever.
Most people.
The other one, poor guy, has my hair. I'm just like, it's Elmer, and I'm.
My hair is like yours.
It goes
this,
out.
This. Yeah. I mean, I add gel to enhance it, but if I was to just let it grow, it would just go kabloo.
I add gel. To enhance it.
Well, I keep it short, but I add gel to enhance the spikes.
So I basically went along the rules of like, I'm not allowed to have hair anymore. I came down to California. I tried cutting my hair and trying to be fashionable.
Well, you have this cul-de-sac going.
An
island.
We have never said it, but yes, it's a cul-de-sac. It used to be parking spots. It used to just like stop. But now you can go around.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Yeah,
make your way around.
Yeah. It's like valet parking all up in there.
It's true. It's sad. I hate it. I really do. Which is why I continue to shave my head. If my wife told me, she's like, why don't you just grow it out? I was like, bitch, you have any idea?
Did you see Beans' picture?
She gets on me about my eyebrows, right? We're talking about two caterpillars fighting over her nose, right? The hair.
Point at my picture. That's what you would look like.
Pretty close.
Yeah. It's not pretty.
Lighter.
Very,
very much so lighter. But
lighter.
I'm an albino version of Beans.
Yes. It would not look pretty. Yeah. He would look 75 years old.
I can't do it.
Yes.
I can't do it.
Uh-uh.
No, it's not going to happen.
No.
So.
With that, I think it's time to,
is it time?
It's 9:00.
I got to get the gun.
Yep.
I'm pretty sure it's time to just put him out of the misery.
Jane's Addiction, you can go fuck yourself. Never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen. Sorry. Peace out, bitches.
True story.
Yep.
They're not coming back.
Now, Rocket, if somebody found us on episode 80, which really...
Where the fuck have you been?
Yeah, you have missed the last 80 weeks.
True story.
80 weeks.
Where
can they, dumbasses, find us?
www.beansandrocket.com.
Fucking A.
Find us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, where you can find highlights from the show. Feel free to join the conversation. We have two feeds on iTunes, HD video and audio. Subscribe and leave us a review. Watch us on Ustream, Facebook Live and Vimeo. We are also on Spreaker and the Stitcher radio app. Feel free to send us an email, email@beansandrocket.com. We read all the emails and your email may make it on the show. And of course, on beansandrocket.com, tell your friends about us and share the show. We are live every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Pacific.
And we're back. I called pizza at 808 and they haven't delivered.
Beans is blaming me.
It's your screaming. They're like, no, we're not delivering shit.
So I have a question for you.
But the police is outside. Not, and I'm not talking like
Would have got more knocking.
When I say the police,
I would be fine to get arrested and get pizza. Just give me a slice.
But give me the pizza
Lock
first.
Lock me up. Just let me eat a slice. We're good. So I have a question for you.
Seven.
Okay, we'll go with that.
Let me call pizza again. I haven't received my pizza. Hold on. Well, let me call pizza first, and let's see what they say. We're gonna put them on speaker real quick.
It's a bad idea.
Please do not. No, please don't.
I won't.
Because I really want to get some food. Oh, shit. They're closed.
Oh. Pizza Yamore, can I help you?
Hi. I was just calling because we haven't received our pizza yet.
Can I help you, Adrian?
Yes, it is. Oh, all right. Thank you.
Sorry about that. Thank you, man.
Thank you. All right. He is on his way. So go ahead.
In short, the Dunn fucked up. So how many episodes?
This is number 80.
And the first go around, we had a game that we played.
The shot count.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
I will pull up the numbers right now. Hold on.
It's a bad idea.
I'm just plugging in.
That's a bad idea.
Because we have some comments. We have some comments. So tell us what the comments are.
Can't read them. Wait for it.
It's coming up. It's coming up.
There we go. He likes options. And then listener Sally said, hello.
Let's see. Beans and Rocket.
I'm pretty sure listener Sally was saying something ahead of that, but I don't know what she said.
That's the latest we have. I don't know. Okay. Latest shot count.
Okay.
We have the shot challenge. And so we have Mr. Rocket on my right.
Over here.
Going at two shots.
Uh-huh.
And Beans going at 0.5 shots.
0.5, which is BS because half shot? What is
half
that?
Half shot. That means okay. I violated
okay.
Broker.
Well, to be fair. So
yes, we hit, that makes sense.
Full shot.
Yeah, yeah,
is,
yeah.
As a tall boy.
Sure.
Half shot is your traditional shot.
Yes.
Which is really a shot. So this actually should be like two shots and this should be one, but whatever. So
yes.
All that being said,
you lost the first time around.
Hard.
And you're still losing this time around.
Oh, of course.
Of course. Would you
I'm
like
not
to say
competitive.
Your name and would you like to say the name of the old show?
No, would you?
Because look at the bottom.
No.
We
I
have
don't.
Pizza coming. We have pizza coming.
So yeah. So we have pizza coming. That's the excuse.
By the way, what do you think of the Japanese whiskey?
Hey,
smooth as fuck though.
It's actually really good.
It's smooth as fuck.
Yeah, you know, so it starts off a very scotchy tone, but as you continue
easy.
Drinking it, no, it's good.
It's an easy sipper.
I like it. I like it a lot.
You and I could kill a bottle.
We did.
Well, almost.
We-ish.
At the end of the night, maybe.
Well, I was gonna say Raul. The
motherfucker drink,
it's
motherfucker
episode
drink, motherfucker
80
drink.
As long as I don't have to pay up to a bet, I'm fine.
Hold on.
So
because you need your headphones.
Oh.
Oh, I like it. I like what he's doing. By the way, you're gonna have to let me know if it's smooth on the way down.
On a shooter?
Yes. Really?
So counts as speeding because yeah. I was speeding.
Right. Yeah.
And then on.
Hold up. How was it?
Smooth. You could handle that. Smooth. Yeah, you could handle that one.
I told you, them Japanese.
If it
damn.
Would be, if it was like Larceny or Elijah, you'd no. be like, nope.
I'd be sipping that shit all night long.
I changed my mind.
This Japanese people, damn.
That's dangerous. I also know that if the pizza doesn't get here soon, I'm gonna need to Uber.
He said a few minutes, so I better hear a door ring.
Kate.
And when that happens, you can entertain the people for about 30 seconds, and then I'll go get the pizza. So now with that.
I'm not going to just entertain the people. I'm going to entertain the delivery guy, too.
So now with that, Rocket, I think we have come to the final part of the show.
I don't want to. All right. So I'll say this much.
We always end the show with what?
Final thought.
By the way, rinse your glass. Shit. 80 episodes. Thank you. It has been fun.
So Beans invited me on the episode.
On the show.
81
weeks ago.
Yeah, 81 weeks ago.
Well.
And.
Go ahead.
I opted into being a part of the show immediately after.
Sure. I remember we were at Rush when we were talking about, we could do a show. And you said, what could it be about? And then 2 hours later, I said, we just spent 2 hours talking about nothing. That is what we're going to do.
And that's and literally like, what the show
yes!
became.
Yeah. Let's do that.
Why not?
Yeah. Exactly. And so, we haven't really changed the format since.
So my wife was like, why do you go out and you do the show? I was like, consider it like bowling night. Like, I'm not going out and I'm trying to do anything crazy. Right. But it was really a matter of
there's
like.
There's a naked girl here. Always. A blonde naked girl.
Cute little blonde.
Cute little blonde.
Her legs aren't very long, but damn them hips. Let me tell you.
I mean, we have a cute little blonde naked girl, but otherwise, it's PG-13.
She gets a little edgy, though. Yeah. She gets a little edgy. Yeah,
she's nervous.
So you invite me out on the show. We say, okay, let's figure something out. We come up with a show idea, and that really was what it was. We came up with just having fun.
Sure.
It's like Seinfeld. A show about nothing.
Yeah.
Do it.
That's what it is.
Anytime anybody has ever asked me, like, okay, you have a podcast. I'm like, literally? Like, it's two guys drinking and talking about whatever the fuck they want.
Yeah, you have to check it out. Yeah. It's hard to describe. Yeah.
Will it ever become syndicated and we'll make millions for being Seinfeld? Like super, super original?
Well, he was on NBC, so we have a handicap.
Yeah. I'll give him
We're on Facebook.
Yeah, bastard. But I will say this much. Every Wednesday is a Wednesday I look forward to. We've always had the opportunity to say whatever we want.
Have some cocktails.
Yeah, have some cocktails. Knowing there's going to be an audience.
Sure.
Regardless of who the audience might be.
We don't know who's watching.
Nope.
And we don't know who's going to watch after the fact.
Nope.
Never.
Which is terrifying. But in the same... In the same regard.
I know my mom has stopped watching a long time ago.
I don't even think I shared the show with my mom.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Maybe.
Maybe. I'll let her know.
Oh, no. She's coming into town. So, that being said, this entire 81 weeks of 81, playing, you know, being behind the bright fluorescent the lights. And
they're not hot, though.
No, they're not. Kudos, LEDs. By the way. Thank God. This series would be super, super short if it was for hotter lights.
You'd be like, whoo.
Yeah, no.
Whoo.
If it wasn't for the fact that I had somebody fun to talk to, somebody that could ping off of me, feed off of, like,
and I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but we could talk about a hat for 3 hours.
We could. I will say this much. It's been a pleasure. It's been a privilege.
Thank you. I had a lot of fun in the process.
It's It's been a good time. So, yeah. For my final thought, this much. Those who are looking to step out of their comfort zone and do something completely outside the realm of what they would typically do, do it. Dive in.
Do it.
Because if you don't, you're missing out. And I have the last year and a half, almost 2 years.
2 years.
To prove to that. It's just been fun.
Have fun.
It's
with
been
it.
Good. Have it's fun been great. It. And I really do appreciate it.
Solid.
I think
it's
number
like it.
Four. I'm going to go with four on that one. So that being said, beans.
My final thought goes out to everybody, boys and girls out there in internet land.
He likes the boys more.
Anybody, everybody, anybody, even listener Terry. She can go fuck herself, but even her.
And say that one.
I know I'm going to get grief next week because she doesn't watch, but she watches.
I do it.
Yeah. So just go out there and be good humans. You have an option to be good or bad. Be good humans. That's it.
Be good. Be great. Good. Be human.
Be human. And with that, Rocket, for the last time. I know. I know.
My name's Rocket.
For the last time for now. How about that?
For now.
You never know.
My name's Rocket. Y'all have an exceptional good night.
Oh, I should met.
Live how you love. Love how you live. Love you guys.
Thank you.
Double hearts.
Thank you. And thank you. And for everybody that has ever joined us on our show, thank you for joining us. Otherwise, we would just be two stupid guys talking in front of a mic. So thank you for joining us. And I'm Beats. And I'm out, bitches.
Ooh. From the Angry Beagle Studios, this has been the Beans and Rocket Show. Make sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Keep the emails coming in at email@beansandrocket.com. Thanks for watching today's show. We'll be back next Wednesday at 7 p.m. Pacific. The Beans and Rocket Show is also available on iTunes, Podcaster, and the Stitcher radio app. For more information about the show, visit our website, beansandrocket.com. My way.